goes to whoever's ticket gets drawn. So then the boosters are giving their entire share of the other half to the donation. Yes, the team share the 50-50 raffle is going. Yep, no problem. Thanks.
Hi Taros fans, I'm Colby Inns. When the Taros get on the bus, the first stop is always at Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Taros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much we eat at the Minot location too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for $20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at libertytax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
All in one place, you can get a fabulous coffee, the best burger in town, arrange a meeting for up to 30 people, and begin your next trip, whether business or vacation. It's Minot's newest, most architecturally beautiful, versatile structure, the Minot International Airport. The Trestle Tap House and Cafe with Caribou Coffee and customizable meeting spaces are just a couple of the amenities offered. The Minot International Airport. See the world from home.
Captain's Cove Seafood Restaurant invites you in for your favorite seafood as well as steak, chicken, and lots of great burgers and sandwiches. The Cove has fish and chips, crab, shrimp, and all-you-can-eat meals. Captain's Cove, where fishing is made easy. 1735 South Broadway in Minot.
Throughout the areas we serve, First International Bank and Trust employees are actively involved in helping our customers and communities grow. This is Kevin Vigestead from First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Whether it's coaching a Little League team, leading through involvement with nonprofit organizations, or a proud Beaver booster, know that all of us at First International Bank and Trust are committed to giving back to the places where we live and work.
I'm here at the year's hottest stag pool party.
Put your antlers up!
Where? Some poor guy's backyard. These stags are bringing down the house. Seriously, deer are ripping holes in the pool cover. They're trampling patio furniture.
And all the damage was covered, thanks to Farmers Insurance. Stag Pool Party, October 27th, 2014. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Charles Forward Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your local's farmer's agent at 701-838-8144.
Hey guys, my name is Steve Olschwanger, fire chief from Maryland Heights, Missouri, and I love Firehouse Subs. Take their meatball sub, for example. It's loaded wall-to-wall with Italian meatballs and a zesty marinara with melted provolone on a toasted roll. And when I say take their meatball sub, I mean it. Grab a medium meatball sub combo to go right now, just $6. But don't forget, the reason Firehouse Subs is driven to make the best subs anywhere is simple. The more subs you enjoy, the more they're able to help save lives because a portion of every purchase goes towards first responders in our communities.
The Firehouse Sub Meatball Sub Combo. Medium meatball sub, your choice of chips and a 22-ounce drink. Get it hot and ready in our to-go box now, just $6 for a limited time only. Order online now at firehousesubs.com. Firehouse Subs, founded by firemen. Firehouse of America will donate 0.13% of your purchases in 2017 at all U.S. locations to the Firehouse Subs Public Safety Foundation with a minimum donation of $1 million. For full details, visit firehousesubs.com.
Hi, Toros fans. I'm Alex Adams. When the Toros get on the bus, the first stop is always Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Toros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much, we eat at the Minot location, too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Take care of your feet, and they'll take care of you. The foot and ankle specialists at Trinity Health can help with both surgical and non-surgical solutions. So, patients who suffer from foot and ankle-related issues can say, so long heel pain, catch you later corns, hasta la vista hammer toes. Relieve pain now and help prevent future discomfort. Diagnosis and treatment is available today. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
We live in such a fast-paced world. It's always go, go, go. When I'm out for a run, it's my time. It's the best way to start your day. Crossing the line of that marathon, it's the biggest reward you can get. I want my customers to achieve their goals and go above and beyond. I'm Nikki Ledeggi, and I'm one of the running experts at Shields.
Shields, when it comes to gear and expert advice, we're right there with you in Bismarck, Minot, Grand Forks, Fargo, and Moorhead.
Hello, I'm Steve Funningsland, consumer lender at First Western Bank and Trust and sports enthusiast. The employees at First Western know the importance of teamwork in their day-to-day banking duties to best serve the community. I know the Minot and surrounding area high school and college athletic teams know the importance of teamwork as well. We want to wish all local teams good luck in their athletic endeavors this year. Stay safe on the courts, on the fields, on the rinks, and in the gyms. We look forward to watching you succeed. With familiar faces you know, who know you by name, First Western Bank and Trust, you can bank on us, member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
All in one place, you can get a fabulous coffee, the best burger in town, arrange a meeting for up to 30 people, and begin your next trip, whether business or vacation. It's Minot's newest, most architecturally beautiful, versatile structure, the Minot International Airport. The Trestle Tap House and Cafe with Caribou Coffee and customizable meeting spaces are just a couple of the amenities offered. The Minot International Airport. See the world from home.
Hi, Taros fans. I'm Lincoln Earn. When the Taros are on the road, we always stop at Applebee's. They always take care of the Taros, giving us the fuel we need to win away from the Mesa. The boys love to eat there after home games, too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Daniel the deer danced everywhere. He pranced through fields and jigged through rivers. Then he saw it. What a stage! A place no deer had dared dance before. The hood of a brand new car.
Hey, my car!
And the car was covered, thanks to Farmers Insurance. Deer Dance Floor, December 1st, 2014. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Toros forward Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your local's farmer's agent at 701-838-8144.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at LibertyTax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hi, Toros fans. I'm Austin Koss. When the Toros get on the bus, the first stop is always at Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Toros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much, we eat it at the Minot location, too. Thanks to Applebee's. When we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
The sinister cries haunted Mary through the night. Dawn neared, and still the voice tormented her. She ran towards the safety of her car, flung open the door, and a coyote had somehow gotten locked inside. But the damaged interior was covered thanks to Farmers Insurance. Coyote Carpool, August 1st, 2015. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Charles Forward Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your local farmer's agent at 701-838-8144.
Hey guys, my name is Steve Olschwanger, fire chief from Maryland Heights, Missouri. I love Firehouse Subs because you can feed your whole crew and help your community thanks to Firehouse Subs. Cater. If you're planning a tailgate, an office holiday party, or anything in between, Firehouse Subs has crowd-pleasing platters starting at just $5 per person. They'll even deliver to you. And of course, you'll be helping your community because a portion of every purchase at Firehouse Subs goes towards helping first responders in our communities. The more subs folks enjoy, the more Firehouse Subs is able to help save lives.
Firehouse Subs Catering. Choose from sub, salad, or dessert platters for your next group gathering. Platters start at just $5 a person. Visit firehousesubs.com to find a location near you. Firehouse Subs, founded by firemen. Firehouse of America will donate 0.13% of your purchases in 2017 at all U.S. locations to the Firehouse Subs Public Safety Foundation with a minimum donation of $1 million. For full details, visit firehousesubs.com. You're gonna
love fire from Ryan. Hi, this is Carson Wentz. While we have a couple seconds, I'd like to tell you why I'm a fan of Ryan Family Dealership. They know the only way to win someone's respect, to earn their business, is by meeting and exceeding their expectations. That's why I buy my vehicles here. Whether it's sales, parts, or service, you can be sure they'll go the extra mile for you. Take it from me, you're gonna love buying from Ryan.
Your hands are a vital part of who you are, how you work, play, even how you communicate. When injury or illness strikes, the hand team at Trinity Health will be there to help restore full functionality. We specialize in surgical repairs, hand reconstruction, non-surgical interventions, and occupational therapies. Don't let damage or disorder take away your hands. See the hand team at Trinity Health. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
Hi Taros fans, I'm Colby Enns. When the Taros get on the bus, the first stop is always at Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Taros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much we eat at the Minot location too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at libertytax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
All in one place, you can get a fabulous coffee, the best burger in town, arrange a meeting for up to 30 people, and begin your next trip, whether business or vacation. It's Minot's newest, most architecturally beautiful, versatile structure, the Minot International Airport. The Trestle Tap House and Cafe with Caribou Coffee and customizable meeting spaces are just a couple of the amenities offered. The Minot International Airport. See the world from home.
Captain's Cove Seafood Restaurant invites you in for your favorite seafood as well as steak, chicken, and lots of great burgers and sandwiches. The Cove has fish and chips, crab, shrimp, and all-you-can-eat meals. Captain's Cove, where fishing is made easy. 1735 South Broadway in Minot.
Throughout the areas we serve, First International Bank and Trust employees are actively involved in helping our customers and communities grow. This is Kevin Biggestead from First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Whether it's coaching a little league team, leading through involvement with nonprofit organizations, or a proud Beaver booster, know that all of us at First International Bank and Trust are committed to giving back to the places where we live and work.
I'm here at the year's hottest stag pool party.
Put your antlers up!
Where? Some poor guy's backyard. These stags are bringing down the house. Seriously, deer are ripping holes in the pool cover. They're trampling patio furniture.
And all the damage was covered, thanks to Farmers Insurance. Stag Pool Party, October 27th, 2014. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Charles Forward, Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your locals farmer's agent at 701-838-8144.
Hey guys, my name is Steve Olschwanger, fire chief from Maryland Heights, Missouri, and I love Firehouse Subs. Take their meatball sub, for example. It's loaded wall-to-wall with Italian meatballs and a zesty marinara with melted provolone on a toasted roll. And when I say take their meatball sub, I mean it. Grab a medium meatball sub combo to go right now, just $6. But don't forget, the reason Firehouse Subs is driven to make the best subs anywhere is simple. The more subs you enjoy, the more they're able to help save lives because a portion of every purchase goes towards first responders in our communities.
The Firehouse Sub Meatball Sub Combo. Medium meatball sub, your choice of chips and a 22-ounce drink. Get it hot and ready in our to-go box, now just $6 for a limited time only. Order online now at firehousesubs.com. Firehouse Subs, founded by firemen. Firehouse of America will donate 0.13% of your purchases in 2017 at all U.S. locations to the Firehouse Subs Public Safety Foundation with a minimum donation of $1 million. For full details, visit firehousesubs.com.
Hi, Toros fans. I'm Alex Adams. When the Toros get on the bus, the first stop is always Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Toros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much, we eat at the Minot location, too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Take care of your feet, and they'll take care of you. The foot and ankle specialists at Trinity Health can help with both surgical and non-surgical solutions. So, patients who suffer from foot and ankle-related issues can say, so long heel pain, catch you later corns, hasta la vista hammer toes. Relieve pain now and help prevent future discomfort. Diagnosis and treatment is available today. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
We live in such a fast-paced world. It's always go, go, go. When I'm out for a run, it's my time. It's the best way to start your day. Crossing the line of that marathon, it's the biggest reward you can get. I want my customers to achieve their goals and go above and beyond. I'm Nikki Ledeggi, and I'm one of the running experts at Shields.
Shields, when it comes to gear and expert advice, we're right there with you in Bismarck, Minot, Grand Forks, Fargo, and Moorhead.
Hello, I'm Steve Funningsland, consumer lender at First Western Bank and Trust and sports enthusiast. Employees at First Western know the importance of teamwork in their day-to-day banking duties to best serve the community. I know the Minot and surrounding area high school and college athletic teams know the importance of teamwork as well. We want to wish all local teams good luck in their athletic endeavors this year. Stay safe on the courts, on the fields, on the rinks, and in the gyms. We look forward to watching you succeed. With familiar faces you know, who know you by name, First Western Bank and Trust, you can bank on us, member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
All in one place, you can get a fabulous coffee, the best burger in town, arrange a meeting for up to 30 people, and begin your next trip, whether business or vacation. It's Minot's newest, most architecturally beautiful, versatile structure, the Minot International Airport. The Trestle Tap House and Cafe with Caribou Coffee and customizable meeting spaces are just a couple of the amenities offered. The Minot International Airport. See the world from home.
Hi, Taros fans. I'm Lincoln Earn. When the Taros are on the road, we always stop at Applebee's. They always take care of the Taros, giving us the fuel we need to win away from the Mesa. The boys love to eat there after home games, too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Daniel the deer danced everywhere. He pranced through fields and jigged through rivers. Then he saw it. What a stage! A place no deer had dared dance before. the hood of a brand new car.
Hey, my car!
And the car was covered, thanks to Farmers Insurance. Deer Dance Floor, December 1st, 2014. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Charles Forward Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your local's farmer's agent at 701-838-8144.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at LibertyTax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hi, Toros fans. I'm Austin Koss. When the Toros get on the bus, the first stop is always at Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Toros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much, we eat it at the Minot location, too. Thanks to Applebee's. When we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
The sinister cries haunted Mary through the night. Dawn neared, and still the voice tormented her. She ran towards the safety of her car, flung open the door, and a coyote had somehow gotten locked inside. But the damaged interior was covered thanks to Farmers Insurance. Coyote Carpool, August 1st, 2015. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Charles Forward Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your local's farmer's agent at 701-838-8144.
Hey guys, my name is Steve Olschwanger, fire chief from Maryland Heights, Missouri. I love Firehouse Subs because you can feed your whole crew and help your community thanks to Firehouse Subs Catering. If you're planning a tailgate, an office holiday party, or anything in between, Firehouse Subs has crowd-pleasing platters starting at just $5 per person. They'll even deliver to you. And of course, you'll be helping your community because a portion of every purchase at Firehouse Subs goes towards helping first responders in our communities. The more subs folks enjoy, the more Firehouse Subs is able to help save lives.
Firehouse Subs Catering. Choose from sub, salad, or dessert platters for your next group gathering. Platters start at just $5 a person. Visit FirehouseSubs.com to find a location near you. Firehouse Subs, founded by firemen. Firehouse of America will donate 0.13% of your purchases in 2017 at all U.S. locations to the Firehouse Subs Public Safety Foundation with a minimum donation of $1 million. For full details, visit FirehouseSubs.com.
You're gonna love fire from Ryan.
Hi, this is Carson Wentz. While we have a couple seconds, I'd like to tell you why I'm a fan of Ryan Family Dealerships. They know the only way to win someone's respect, to earn their business, is by meeting and exceeding their expectations. That's why I buy my vehicles here. Whether it's sales, parts, or service, you can be sure they'll go the extra mile for you. Take it from me, you're gonna love buying from Ryan.
Your hands are a vital part of who you are, how you work, play, even how you communicate. When injury or illness strikes, the hand team at Trinity Health will be there to help restore full functionality. We specialize in surgical repairs, hand reconstruction, non-surgical interventions, and occupational therapies. Don't let damage or disorder take away your hands. See the hand team at Trinity Health. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
Hi, Toros fans. I'm Colby Enns. When the Toros get on the bus, the first stop is always at Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Toros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much, we eat at the Minot location, too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at LibertyTax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
All in one place, you can get a fabulous coffee, the best burger in town, arrange a meeting for up to 30 people, and begin your next trip, whether business or vacation. It's Minot's newest, most architecturally beautiful, versatile structure, the Minot International Airport. The Trestle Tap House and Cafe with Caribou Coffee and customizable meeting spaces are just a couple of the amenities offered. The Minot International Airport. See the world from home.
Captain's Cove Seafood Restaurant invites you in for your favorite seafood as well as steak, chicken, and lots of great burgers and sandwiches. The Cove has fish and chips, crab, shrimp, and all-you-can-eat meals. Captain's Cove, where fishing is made easy. 1735 South Broadway in Minot.
Throughout the areas we serve, First International Bank and Trust employees are actively involved in helping our customers and communities grow. This is Kevin Vigestead from First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Whether it's coaching a Little League team, leading through involvement with nonprofit organizations, or a proud Beaver booster, know that all of us at First International Bank and Trust are committed to giving back to the places where we live and work.
I'm here at the year's hottest stag pool party.
Put your antlers up!
Where? Some poor guy's backyard. These stags are bringing down the house. Seriously, deer are ripping holes in the pool cover. They're trampling patio furniture.
And all the damage was covered, thanks to Farmers Insurance. Stag Pool Party, October 27th, 2014. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Charles Forward, Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your local's farmer's agent at 701-838-8144.
It's time for Minotauros Hockey on the Toros Network, AM 1390 KRRZ and HockeyTV.com. Toros Hockey is brought to you by Farmers Union Insurance, Gooseneck Implement, Mattress Firm, Liberty Tax, and Coulter Energy. Now let's go live to the Farmers Union Insurance pregame show with Ken Oda and Brad Beru.
Hello and welcome inside the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena as we get ready for the final home game of the regular season. Final game of the regular season, not just for the Toros or the Wings, but for the entire league. We're the last start of the on the league, schedule. Yeah. So we, with the 7:35 start, the last game of the season in the North American Hockey League. And Brad, I think last night fans who were listening heard us debating whether or not you go with the full lineup or you play the young guys who are in town, the AP players and tender players, and it looks like we were both kind of right.
Yeah, I mean, it looks about 70%.
Guys like Muha and Lovin draw back in, guys who I probably didn't expect to play, but also you still have some of the young guys in the lineup, so it looks like Marty Murray and the Toros coaching staff electing to give guys one game off this weekend for the most part. Talbot sits tonight, and
Boost, London, Racing.
Yeah, so a little bit of a mix and match, but, you know, tonight's game doesn't mean a ton in the standings, and really, Brad, after the events of last night, it's hard to feel like any games really mean all that much.
No, absolutely. Yeah, it's just a tough day to even think about playing hockey, I guess.
You know, it's been the talk of the hockey world, the tragedy up north, and I don't even know what to say anymore at this point. It's just, it's really, I mean, all we've talked about in the office, you brought up the Swift Current accident years ago, and this is significantly worse.
Yeah, you know, we first reported it during the game yesterday. It was obviously very, very early in the investigation of the accidents, and then the numbers, unfortunately, changed and rose. And, it's a sad day, and a day that, and I don't say this very often, Ken, I don't really feel like watching hockey.
Yeah, and our thoughts and prayers are out to the Humboldt Broncos and the families that lost the families that will have to aid their players on what's, I'm sure, to be a long road to recovery. And, you know, I will say I'm proud of the Minotauros Booster Club tonight. The pot from the 50-50 draw will be going to the fund to help the Humboldt Broncos. And I believe they've also got a donation box going. And I know the Minot community's always been very generous since I've been here, at least. And hopefully we raise a lot of money, because on the ice tonight, it doesn't feel like a whole lot matters.
No, it sure doesn't. It's just a tragic event. And we wish them the best. And our thoughts and prayers are definitely with the community of Humboldt, the family, friends, teammates, and everybody involved in such a tragic event.
But we will turn our attention back to hockey tonight. And the Toros and Wings, a bad game for the Toros. There's no sugarcoating last night's loss. A 2-1 loss. Didn't look that bad on the scoreboard, but outshot 40-15 and only got five shots after falling behind in that one in the second period. So really not a very encouraging effort. I know the coaching staff was not pleased, and you know, it'll be interesting to see how this group comes out tonight.
Oh, I definitely will. I think we had a couple positives last night in the fact that I was very happy with Lonkala coming back from injury. And tonight will be test number two to see how his stamina is after coming back from his illness, and to see if he can handle two nights in a row. And that's going to be important next week, that he can handle two nights in a row. As far as other than that, it really wasn't. I was trying to think of a scoring chance that we had last night, and I really couldn't come up with one, Ken.
No, even the goal the Toros got was a misplay by the goaltender behind the net that ends up in the back of the cage. But the other thing to keep an eye on tonight, Brookings is done for the year. Miroslav Muha and Burke for the Wings are both a point behind Boyer for the division scoring lead. So with a two-point night for either of them, we could have the division's leading scorer. So it'll be interesting to see how much they gun for that, if that matters to them.
Oh, they probably will say it isn't the biggest thing in the world, but probably is deep down. Anybody that has any bit of competitiveness in them wants to lead their division in scoring, that's for sure.
We'll take a short break. When we come back, we'll catch the pregame festivities here at the Mesa Arena after this on the Minotauros Network.
Hey guys, my name is Steve Olswanger, Fire Chief from Maryland Heights, Missouri, and I love Firehouse Subs. Take their meatball sub, for example. It's loaded wall-to-wall with Italian meatballs and a zesty marinara with melted provolone on a toasted roll. And when I say take their meatball sub, I mean it. Grab a medium meatball sub combo to go right now, just $6. But don't forget, the reason Firehouse Subs is driven to make the best subs anywhere is simple. The more subs you enjoy, the more they're able to help save lives, because a portion of every purchase goes towards first responders in our communities.
The Firehouse Sub Meatball Sub Combo. Medium meatball sub, your choice of chips and a 22-ounce drink. Get it hot and ready in our to-go box, now just $6 for a limited time only. Order online now at firehousesubs.com. Firehouse Subs, founded by firemen. Firehouse of America will donate 0.13% of your purchases in 2017 at all U.S. locations to the Firehouse Subs Public Safety Foundation, with a minimum donation of $1 million. For full details, visit firehousesubs.com.
Hi, Toros fans. I'm Alex Adams. When the Toros get on the bus, the first stop is always Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Toros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much, we eat at the Minot location.
Applebee's 2 for $20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Take care of your feet, and they'll take care of you. The foot and ankle specialists at Trinity Health can help with both surgical and non-surgical solutions. So patients who suffer from foot and ankle-related issues can say, so long heel pain, catch you later corns, hasta la vista hammer toes. Relieve pain now and help prevent future discomfort. Diagnosis and treatment is available today. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena. We're going to turn you over to the PA system here for the end of the pregame video, as well as the starting lineups and the rest of the pregame festivities.
Hey Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena for tonight's North American Hockey League game. Tonight's matchup features the visiting Aberdeen Wings against Yar Minot Minnesota. I've got one question for you fans. Are you ready for Minnesota's hockey? Treats. Welcome to the ice, your Minot Minnesota! And now it's time to meet your Planet Pizza Minnesota's starting lineups. Pingo from Kuopio, Finland, wearing sweater number 35, Samu Lonkina! On defense from Brighton, Michigan, wearing sweater number 14, Spencer Kimball! On defense from Minot, North Dakota, wearing sweater number 5, Kobe Enns. At center from Prague, Czech Republic, wearing sweater number 19, Andre Pavel. On right wing from Muskego, Wisconsin, wearing sweater number 27, Ryan Green. And on left wing from Red Wing, Minnesota, wearing sweater number 25, Fritz Blair. The Toros, Kevin's Auto Body and N83 Fireworks honorary captain of the game is Brady Doctor. That's your Planet Pizza Minnesota starting lineups. The Toros are head coached by Marty Murray, assisted by Shane Wagner and Wyatt Westlinchuk. Toros fans, please rise and join the Minot Minnesotas, Aberdeen Wings, and the North American Hockey League, and the entire hockey community across North America in mourning the events that occurred for the Humboldt Broncos junior hockey team of the Saskatchewan Junior Hockey League. As they traveled to their playoff game yesterday, the team bus carrying 28 players and staff was hit by a tractor trailer, killing 14 and injuring 14 others. We ask that you please keep the players' families, coaches, staff, and team management in your thoughts and prayers as we now observe 14 seconds of silence for this unspeakable tragedy. Toros fans, at this time, we ask that you remain standing, remove all headgear, and welcome Steve Brown to the ice for the singing of the Star Spangled Banner.
Stars through the veil of the sky.
With the pregame festivities just about out of the way, we're almost ready to drop the puck here in Minot. Brad, tonight's game doesn't mean much in the standings, but with so many of the big guns playing for both sides, you got to think it means something for the next five.
Well, you know, you got Aberdeen's on a five-game winning streak, and the Toros are on a five-game losing streak. Well,
four now.
Excuse me. So we want to change that going into the playoffs.
Certainly do. Last regular season game in the North American Hockey League, Toros and Aberdeen Wings. Toros wearing the home white sweaters, or home cream sweaters, I should say. Aberdeen in the traveling black. Same officiating crew as last night, Logan Gruel wearing the orange armbands. Toros control off the draw, and Pavel chips it deep into the far side corner. Belisle gives chase, but the Wings, Weigel, wins it to the near side. Pavel tries to play back down the wall. Green steps in as well, kept at the point by Colby Enns. His shot is blocked. Toros look to work in the far corner, but it's taken away, and Fletcher starts up the near side. And Brad, with Keenan Lund still out tonight, I'm interested to see how Ryan Green does on this line with his speed. It's similar to that of Lund.
Yeah, I've really liked this line's play over the last month, and it's good to see him back in the lineup.
Toros control. I don't believe the Wings ever got a shot on goal on that rush, and now Mucha on the near side. Miro chips it deep. Lovin gives chase. Adams is there as well, but it's swept to the far side. Miro hunts it down. Chips down the wall. It'll find Lovin in the corner. Lovin spins it to the front. It cut off nicely by the captain, Kelly, of the Wings. Far side, Lovin looking to work a cycle. Tack to tape for Lovin. Lovin works it down low to Mucha. Miro comes across to the near side. McGinnis catches a carom off the wall, and he'll just chip it deep for Adams. Adams wins a battle along the wall, keeps it working with a cycle to Lovin. Lovin trying to spin back the way he came. He beats a man off the wall. Lovin working, carries down low, works it to the front where it's covered for a whistle.
Goalie change tonight for Aberdeen is Vinyl's in. He's at 2.27 goals against average, .915 save percentage. And back for a second night in a row after a long-term illness is Sam Mulonkila, .916 save percentage, 2.51 goals against average, and I was very impressed with his play last night, Ken.
Saw 40 shots in his first game back. Probably a little more than he would have liked.
Yeah.
But all in all, a pretty good night, only allowing two. Digging on the near side, and, you know, big hit by Adams. I would say, of those two goals he allowed in, I don't think either one was soft, which is also something you worry about with a goaltender coming back from injury. Adams hit hard on the far side. Puck taken over on the far wall. Dahlemer steps in, frees it up for Lance, who gives it right back to Sinard. It's punched out to neutral ice. Dumped in on goal by Kalik, the East Grand Forks High School product. He's been out to skate a couple times with the Toros, seeing his first game action. This is moved ahead along the near side. Pitters into the zone. Pitters taken into the wall by Kalik. They'll dig. Squirts back to the point. Britt's shot tipped wide by Sladek. Played into the near side corner. Bauer. Bauer gets help from Kalik. Kalik plays along to the far side corner and Lincoln Earn. Earn banks it back to the near corner. Kalik starts up ice, plays in the middle for Ness. Ness looking for Bauer. Toros gained the line. I thought Ness was offside, but apparently not. Doesn't matter as Rahowiak steps in and takes it away. Rahowiak up the far side looking to get it to the front. Never got it there. Now Bauer on the near side. Moving it along the wall. Kangas plays it out to neutral ice. Toss across, finds Pitters. Pitters into the zone, hits the brakes, plays it back to the point. Britt looking for a tip. He didn't get it. It was Rahowiak in front. Across, Britt's shot is blocked by Bauer. And now he'll look to start the Toros out. Gains the red line, has it poked free. It kicks back to the Toro blue. Kimball across for Enns. Enns comes right back to Spencer Kimball. Colby Enns up the middle. He'll look to wheel. Enns carries over the red and the blue as he looks to go coast to coast. Enns shot on, save made. Rebound was there, but Bauer couldn't find it. The rebound kicks all the way down to the Toro blue line where Spencer looks to gain the zone, plays into the middle. Molinar. Molinar shot, save made. Lankala out far to challenge that one. I don't remember Samu getting out that far to challenge shooters very often. Shot blocked out front by Pavel. Pav finds Green. Green pokes it into the zone, but Sennard steps in and takes it away. Played in behind the net, taken over there. They work it down into the corner. Working on the far wall is Rosenbaum. And behind, Sennard comes across for Heward. Heward stepped into. Green frees it up, can't get it to the front. Far corner, it's taken over by Spencer. Spencer comes across the near side. Heward chips ahead. Mukhop pokes that out of midair. Tries to gather it in. He's tied up a bit. Molinar steps in. He'll look to play behind the safety of his own net, but Miro takes it away, finds Adams in the far corner. Adams looking for Lovin, but the pass is tipped away by Sennard, and the wings will go the other way. It's Riley Murphy. Murphy through Rosenbaum, but cleaning it up on the back check was Lovin. Lovin finds Rosenbaum. Rosenbaum spins away, and he'll retreat behind the safety of the Toro cage. We're 5 minutes in, Brad. I don't think we've had a whistle.
We have not had a whistle. One. We had one whistle.
And only one shot on goal. This is Burke. And it was the Toros who took that shot.
Which I don't understand, because Lankala made a good save on one that wouldn't have went wide. So
this is Fletcher pinning a man to the wall. Lovin lands on top of him. Long shot from the point goes wide. Lovin finds it and starts Alex Adams up ice. Three on two of the Toros. Hurry, Mucha. Looking back into the middle, it never got through to Adams. Defended nicely by Mikowski. Earn steps in and pokes it free, but it's ahead to Fletcher anyways. Fletcher working on Kimball. Forced to turn by Kimball, and then it's played down into the corner. Lance chases to the near corner. Tries to one-hand it along the wall. Strott is there as well. It's freed up for Mucha. Mucha makes a pass out to neutral ice. It was just a little long for Dolomer. Into the middle, Rahowiak. He's stood up by Spencer Kimball. And it's chipped down into the corner. Enns finds it there. Sweeps along to the far side. Pitters plays give and go with Strada. Puts one on net that's covered by Lankala for a whistle. 13:51 left to play here in a scoreless first period.
A period that's on fast forward, Ken.
Yeah. Hey, I'm okay with that. I don't mind a lack of whistles. Pitters and Dolomer on the draw to the right of Lankala. The Lindemans are checking in on Twitter. Good to have you guys aboard as we play the final game of the regular season. Dolomer fell down. This is Pitters. Backhand try. Stick to side by Lankala. Lance on the far side gathers it in and starts the Toros up ice. Lance toss across, finds Kimball. Kimball carries into the zone on the near side, drops one back for Dolomer. Dolomer forced to turn at the hash marks, looks for the trailer. It's Colby Enns, walks around, walks in, shot, blocker save. Puck poked free along the near wall. Adams upended. That's Brian Adams. Centering feed for Brian Adams is taken away, and now the wings will start up the near side. McGinnis steps up, took it away for a moment, but Rahowiak won it back, and now
offside. Strada was in offsides on that one.
He was in so far offside, I had to go looking for him.
He was a good 5 or 6 feet in.
Two shots on goal aside, none have gone in yet. We've played 6 minutes and 51 seconds so far here. In period number one, Toros and Wings are scoreless. McGinnis, D to D with Rosenbaum. Rosenbaum ahead. Touched into the zone and then poked right back out. This won't go. Will it go far enough for icing? It does.
But they wave it off.
For no real reason. Bauer's pass ahead for Ness is broken up. Bauer gets it back, though, works along the wall. Kangas touches it into the zone. Toros will chase, but Sennard is there first. Sennard leaned on by Bauer. Good hit, kept at the point by McGinnis. That turnover was created by the pressure from Bauer. Now Kangas looking to walk off the wall. Can't chop it to the front. Ness is there as well. Kangas takes it back. They've got Belial lurking in front of the net. Kangas doesn't get it there, though. Kangas now working a cycle with Belisle. Comes back to Kangas. Gives to Ness. Touches up top to McGinnis. McGinnis tries a shot through traffic. Save made. Belisle leaves for McGinnis. McGinnis carries down the wall. Looks to walk in. Backhand try. Save made. Rebound. Hopped over Kangas and Pavel sticks. Rosenbaum pinching down deep. Now he leaves for Pavel. Pavel looking to walk in. Lost the handle and it rolls on net for a cover. And a generous shot on goal for the Toros, who now lead the shot total 5-2. I don't think that last one should have ticked up.
No, absolutely not. That was probably the best chance that we've seen all weekend for the Toros, was Kangas on the doorstep there.
Good morning wishes from Stanislav Pavel watching in the Czech Republic. The Kimballs in Michigan and the Rosenbaums, I assume, still in Newport Beach. Good to have everyone aboard as we get ready for the Central Division semifinals next week. This one poked out to neutral ice. Earn looks to play across for Kolick. Kolick plays ahead, banked for Green, but the pass didn't take the right angle. Belisle steps up at the blue line. Murphy has Birkin offside, and now it gets by Kolick. Shot save made by Lankula. On Fletcher. Fletcher had 2 points last night. That one's dumped in, a goal and an assist. Stick frees it up. Belisle's shot is blocked. Far side, Weigel ahead for Burke. Burke works on Kimball. Kimball takes it away from the wing's leading scorer. Pavel chips it down into the far corner. Adams gives chase. He's got Mihojak lined up. I just combined two names. That's Mikowski. This is Mucha taking it away. Miro dancing through. Now he just flicks one down in the corner for Alex Adams. Adams up top. Kimball. Kimball can't hold the pass, and now it's a race the other way. Sladek gets there, but Loven did well to recover and free that up. Grant Loven having a strong first period, but now one comes out front that's stopped by Lankula. Rebound controlled by Colby Enns, who skates away from Sladek like it's nothing. This is Mucha. Miro flips it into the zone. Mikowski D to D with Kelly. Kelly ahead, and it's touched deep into the Toro zone. Lankula out of his net. He'll stop it and leave for Rosenbaum. Rosie to the far side, gets help from Lance. Lance will cut up the middle. Lance flicks to the far side and Dolimer. Dolimer gains the red line, gets spun down, however, and Rahojak looks to attack. He's got Strada with him into the middle. That missed everyone. And it's down into the near corner. Picked up there by Brian Adams. His pass ahead for Lance hops over his stick. Sinard takes it away. Plays ahead to Strada. Strada looks into the middle for Pitters. Pitters looking back door. The pass was behind Rahojak. Freed up near side. Glass and out by Lance. But dumped right back in by Heward. Out of his net to stop is Lankula. Misplayed that a little bit. This is McGinnis.
Both Pitters on the doorstep, gets a backhand. Lankula throws out the leg to make a big-time save on a grade-A chance.
That's a huge save for Lankula. Now back on the attack is Weigel. Backhand's one that's blocker to side. That one much easier.
Oh, turnovers.
Near side, Weigel keeps it.
Rosenbaum fires it down.
Weigel will find it there. This is dumped into the far corner.
Ness's stick got up on Weigel. No call as the referee had his back turned.
Far side, glass and out for the wings, and now Burke might get a fortunate bounce. Kolick is back. He takes Burke into the end wall. Touched ahead. It hops on Kangas.
Sue, that's all close to too many men. It's offsides.
It is, and the whistle goes. .820 left to go here in period number one. Toros and...
You don't even need me here tonight, Ken.
Yeah. There haven't been many whistles. Good flow to this one so far. Well, Shots on goal are 6-4 in favor of the Toros.
We're halfway to last night's total.
Just about, yeah. The Toros and Wings are still scoreless. And Brad, you know, I know it's early and he's only had maybe three or four shifts, but I've liked Casey Pollock so far.
Yeah, I have too. It is definitely early, but so far so good as he looks composed out there. And he's
a very smooth skater.
Yeah, he had Burke, one of the top scorers, coming in on him, and he did real well to defend that.
This is chipped into the corner. They play along the near side, centering feed. That, thankfully, missed everyone. And now a shot that's gloved by Lonkula. And that
Murphy tipped that up into the air, and I don't think it would have went into the net, but Lonkula threw the glove up there and snagged it out of the air.
8:07 left to go in period. Number one, Toros and Wings are scoreless. Pavel wins the draw back. Kolick has trouble with it. It caught the back,
the back of the net.
Yeah.
Whoa,
this is a bad pass that turns over to Fletcher. Loose puck. Good stick lift by Green. Now Pavel with a nice move. This can turn into a 3-on-2 if the Toros hurry. It's in the middle of Belisle. He was looking for Green, but Murphy intercepted that pass. Chip to the near side. Pav guides it back to the point, but that missed Kimball. And the Toros have to retreat and retrieve. Back in their own zone. Carried ahead by Enns. Enns walks in. Wires. That's stopped by Vinyl, who holds and covers for a whistle.
Enns is looked good tonight, too. That move he had in the corner to escape out of traffic was dynamite, and he's had two good offensive chances also.
We've got Savannah Patterson checking in from Kansas. The Sawchucks from Winnipeg. Near side. It's dumped in by the Wings. Moved around to the near. Ends with it. Softly chips ahead. Alex Adams looks to keep it moving. He's able to take it out to neutral ice. It hits the linesman and results in a fortunate bounce for the Toros. Now Lovin, that was offside.
And it was.
It was, yes.
I didn't think the linesman was going to get there to call that. He was behind the play.
Interesting situation in the division tonight. The Minnesota Wilderness are done. They played Brookings Thursday and Friday. A scheduling issue forced them to take the game off of Saturday night. So they are done, but they are tied with the Austin Bruins at 72 points. But the Bruins are still playing tonight, and right now, through one, they're up 4-1 on Bismarck.
Oh, jeez.
This bouncing puck. So
good effort, Bobcats.
If Austin holds on, which I got to think they will at this point. This is back to the point. McGinnis's shot is blocked down to Lovin.
Since four goals is more than Bismarck scored in the last four games.
Yes, this is McGinnis just chipping one deep. It hit a skate, bounced into the circle, glove down by Weigel. But if Austin holds on to win, they will be the two seed. If Bismarck comes back and wins in regulation,
then the Wilderness would step into that home ice advantage.
Would get home ice. So I imagine there's a lot of interested people in Cloquet watching the game down in Austin tonight.
Probably fueling up the bus, though.
Yes, I would think so. This is played across for Rosenbaum. Rosie comes ahead. He's bumped down. Touched and given over for a shot that goes off the tip of Lonkula's glove from Spencer. Adams wins it on the wall, plays to Kolick. Kolick ahead. He wanted Lance, but it was tipped away. This won't be icing because the Wings touched it. Far side. Mikowski gives up for Strada. Strada working one on four. Gets dumped down by Brian Adams. That will endear the new Toro to the home fans.
He's my favorite already.
into the corner. Lance touches for Adams. Adams delays. Now comes a cross for Earn. Earn looking back into the middle. Wanted a tip from Lance, but it's broken up.
Oh, boy.
Bauer had Strada lined up.
He could have knocked him into next week.
I'm actually glad he... that.
Why?
Delayed call.
What?
That would have been a bad hit from behind.
It's time.
What have we got?
Are they calling him because he got too close to Strada?
Head contact. They all...
On who? Are they calling that when
they're
he hit Strada?
They're calling that non-hit. Head
he
contact.
Let up. He didn't even hit him. He let up. Well, in that fact, he should have drilled him.
Yeah,
then.
If they're calling,
they're going to get a penalty for skating by the guy. We might as well knock him out.
It's not his fault. Strada's 3 foot seven.
I haven't seen that though, Ken. Where they just call it. He let up.
Yeah.
He let. He pulled the chute so he wouldn't hit. Didn't hit him.
I even moved around him. If he got him, he barely got him.
Oh, stuff like that.
And Strada, who's notorious within the division for acting, didn't even pretend.
No, absolutely he didn't.
Speaking of Strada, here he is winding it up into the middle. Lost the handle, back to the point, now taken away. Pav.
Oh, he could have just tipped it up.
If he catches that cleanly, he's gone shorthanded. But now the Wings can set it up. This is Britt walking to the top of the umbrella. Comes to Bendorf, still play catch. Britt delays, leaves for Bendorf. Bendorf leaves up top for Strada. Strada comes across. Britt's shot goes wide.
Oh, this could be a breakaway here.
Around to the far side. Pav trying to poke for Belial. He finds him. Belial hooked down, and the Toros. Speed causing problems. Evens it up at 4 aside for a minute 15. Then the Toros will have an abbreviated power play. So Bendorf goes for the hook. Draw will be to the left of Vinyl. Shots 7-4 with 4:11 to go here in the first. We're still scoreless. Dolomer, Adams, McGinnis, and Rosenbaum. Far side. Murphy chips it in. It barely catches the top of the glass and it rolls down into the corner. Fletcher holds. Carries around. Now Fletcher delaying. 48 seconds left in the 4-on-4s. This is down into the corner. Rosenbaum takes it away. He gets upended in the near corner. And now Murphy plays back to the point. Long shot, gloved and held. And now Fletcher and Rosenbaum joust a little. 32 seconds left in the 4-on-4.
I'd like to see Rosenbaum go. I got a feeling he'd be one of those guys. It's a little bit smaller, but boy, he'd be able to really out-muscle guys.
50-50 draw tonight. Already over $300. The 50-50 here usually caps out at about 4 by the middle of the third period. So now a turnover. Lankala shuts it down. Bohoyak. And that's not counting fans throwing into the donation jar as well. Ends ahead for Ness. Ness into the middle. He missed Earn. Far side. Carried into the zone. Bohoyak from the high slot tries a shot caught off by Lankala. Toros come full strength. They've got a power play for 40 seconds. Earn holds behind the Toro net. Toros will start up. 3 across. 2 trailers. Earn drops it for Miro. Miro comes for Adams. Adams gains the line. Alex Adams hits the brakes at the bottom of the circle. Plays up top. Lincoln Earn sweeps across for Colby Enns. tries a shot. It's blocked out front, tipped up and out of play for a whistle. 2:26 left to go in period number one. 16 seconds left on the Toros power play. Bendorf, 2 minutes for hooking. A minute 44 to go. The draw to the left of Vinyl. Lovin to take it for the Toros. The Wings win it. Play around to the near side. It hops on Lincoln Earn, and the Toros will have to retreat and retrieve. Samu Lonkala stops for Earn. Earn drops back for Alex Adams. Adams looks across for Mucha, who spins it deep. The Wings come full strength. Adams and Kelly come together, and the two captains, Kelly wins the battle. Mikowski ahead. That was a bit of a dive there. That doesn't draw a call. Allows the Toros to take over. Mucha leaves for Adams. Adams down the wall. It's poked free for Mucha. Miro looking to walk in. Now he looks to backhand one across. It's cut off.
Not a pass that's normally going to get through.
Blind through the slot on your backhand?
No.
No. McGinnis will chip that in. And he missed the glass. 1:33 left to go here in period number one.
Bring the first puck out of play each period of merchandise for a free Jimmy John's gift card.
Ness flanked by Bauer and Kangas.
Aberdeen is short a player. Yep, coach, penalty's over. Let's go.
Rahoyak, Pitters, and Strada. The forward core.
When you're on the bench and your line is out there, that's not a good thing.
So Pitters gets tossed. Strada steps in, and the Toros win the draw back. Ness won it, but it missed the defenseman, so McGinnis had to go back and get it. He leaves for Rosenbaum. Minute 24 left in the period. Carried along the near side. Poked deep into the zone. Far side, Kangas tied up. Bouncing puck. Down the wall. The Wings take over. Weigel to the near side. Plays ahead. That missed Strada. Rosenbaum back on it. Touches back to the near side. Wings player falls down. It was Rahoyak. That allows Bauer up ice. 3-on-2 if the Toros hurry. Bauer's played nicely along the wall by Logan Britt. Pass ahead for Strada. 3-on-2 now for the Wings. Strada into the middle for Britt. Britt wide around Lance, looks to center. It's broken up by a stick from one of the three Toros that was there. Couldn't tell which. Pitters walks in. Shot save made. It's behind him.
Rosenbaum saves today.
Now Kangas looking to go with 30 seconds left. Kangas gains the line.
Oh, nice.
His pass along the blue line left the zone. Toros just ring it deep now. 22 seconds. Britt ahead. This will go all the way down the ice. I thought Burke was offside, but apparently not. Now he takes it away. Fletcher kicks to the stick, and Lonkala fights it off as he gets back to the cage. Did you not think Burke was in on early on that to save the icing?
I don't know. I guess I wasn't right. I didn't have an eye on him when he was right at the blue line.
There's a shot blocked off by traffic, and the horn sounds to end it. We are through. 1 period, Toros and Wings are scoreless. We'll take a commercial break. Come back with the intermission report after these messages here on the Minotauros Network.
We live in such a fast-paced world. It's always go, go, go. When I'm out for a run, it's my time. It's the best way to start your day. Crossing the line of that marathon, it's the biggest reward you can get. I want my customers to achieve their goals and go above and beyond. I'm Nikki Ledeggi, and I'm one of the running experts at Shields.
Shields, when it comes to gear and expert advice, we're right there with you in Bismarck, Minot, Grand Forks, Fargo, and Moorhead.
Hello, I'm Steve Funningsland, consumer lender at First Western Bank and Trust and sports enthusiast. Employees at First Western know the importance of teamwork in their day-to-day banking duties to best serve the community. I know the Minot and surrounding area high school and college athletic teams know the importance of teamwork as well. We want to wish all local teams good luck in their athletic endeavors this year. Stay safe on the courts, on the fields, on the rinks, and in the gyms. We look forward to watching you succeed. With familiar faces you know you by name, First Western Bank and Trust, you can bank on us, member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
All in one place. You can get a fabulous coffee, the best burger in town,
Arrange a meeting for up to 30 people and begin your next trip, whether business or vacation. It's Minot's newest, most architecturally beautiful, versatile structure, the Minot International Airport. The Trestle Tap House and Cafe with Caribou Coffee and customizable meeting spaces are just a couple of the amenities offered. The Minot International Airport. See the world from home.
Hi, Taros fans. I'm Lincoln Earn. When the Taros are on the road, we always stop at Applebee's. They always take care of the Taros, giving us the fuel we need to win away from the Mesa. The boys love to eat there after home games, too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Daniel the Deer danced everywhere. He pranced through fields and jigged through rivers. Then he saw it. What a stage! A place no deer had dared dance before. The hood of a brand new car.
Hey, my car!
And the car was covered, thanks to Farmers Insurance. Deer Dance Floor, December 1st, 2014. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Charles Forward Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your locals farmer's agent at 701-838-8144.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at libertytax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena. We're through 20 minutes of play here on the Minotauros Network. Toros and Aberdeen Wings in the final regular season game of the season. Our scoreless, and Brad, before we get to the game, right now fans watching on Hockey TV can see the Billet families are all out on the ice. It's Billet Family Appreciation Night, and, you know, you've been a Billet. You can speak to it better than I can. I've had a player crash for a week here or there, but the Billet families opening up their homes and taking in these players to help them chase their dreams is really something special and something we couldn't do what we do without.
Oh, this is so critical to junior hockey, and all these people out here on the ice, you know, deserve a huge round of applause because it's a huge thing. You know, you're bringing in a person that you don't even know. You meet them for the first day, and they move into your home. And it usually turns into a lifelong bond. But, you know, it is just a big commitment, and it is wonderful. And you can't have junior hockey without wonderful billets.
Certainly can't. And, you know, last year my girlfriend was new to the junior hockey world. She came down for the final games of the season in Aberdeen, that playoff series. And, you know, we lost, unfortunately, that last game four there. And some of the Billet families had made the trip, and some of the younger kids were crying. And my girlfriend, after the game, was kind of surprised to see the little kids cry. She said, yeah, we lost, and the season's over, but I'm surprised they care that much. And I explained to her, it wasn't just that the season was over, but, you know, for some of the guys, it was Luke Davison's Billet family. And he had been here for three full seasons in Minot. His Billet brother, who was only 6 years old, Davey, literally lived there half his kid's life.
Yeah.
To that little Billet brother, Davey was like an older brother, and, you know, it is quite the bond. And for these guys who come here, like you said, moving in, not knowing each other, by the end of two or three seasons of living with these families, they are family.
Absolutely. And, you know, even away from the Billets, these players, when they're here for 2 years, 1 year even, develop a lot of bonds with fans.
Yes.
And kids in the community and stuff. And I know, I'm speaking for my kids, I've had a couple of the Toros work for me at the store I manage, and My kids, we became really close to these players. Yeah. They would come over and have pizza at our house and whatnot and watch some hockey games at our house. And I still have contact with almost all of them to this day. And it's still fun to watch how they're doing in their hockey career and in their life. And these billets and fans are a big part of these young players' lives and vice versa.
And, you know, like you said, it's a bond that goes on longer. I know we had... We still have players who come back in the summer, even though they're, you know, juniors or seniors in college. They take a week of their summer and they come back and visit their billet family because of that bond. And
yeah,
you know, I can't imagine if you didn't grow up in the hockey world and you don't know what it is to jump in and become such a fan that you say, you know what, we're going to open our house to an 18-year-old boy, feed him and take care of him, and you know, and they do it just because they're huge hockey fans and they want to help these guys chase their dreams. But we'll turn our attention back to tonight's game. Not a lot of numbers to go over. We're still scoreless. Toro's outshot 10-8.
Should be like last night, Ken. Not a lot to talk about.
But the Toro's outshot 10-8. Samu Lankala again looks strong. That is encouraging. Grant Lovin, Alex Adams, and Miroslav Muha as well. That line looked to be its normal self. They haven't put one in, but they've controlled play down in the offensive zone. And, you know, Pavel and Belial look good on the penalty kill again, creating an offensive chance while shorthanded and drawing a penalty. So
yep.
I think while there's still no score, the play's been encouraging.
Absolutely. I thought that was a good first period, actually. I thought we had a couple of players on the back end. I was pretty impressed with Kalak in his first game, and I thought Colby Enns had a really good period. And as a whole, I mean, 0-0, but I'm not disappointed at all. I thought we gave maybe a little bit too many offensive chances for Aberdeen, but better than last night, and hopefully we're moving in the right direction.
We'll take another commercial break here. When we come back, we'll take a look around the rest of the league and the NHL as well. Here on the Minotauros Network.
Hi, Taurus fans. I'm Austin Koss. When the Toros get on the bus, the first stop is always at Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Toros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much, we eat it at the Minot location, too. Thanks to Applebee's. When we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood. The sinister cries haunted Mary through the night. Dawn neared, and still the voice tormented her. She ran towards the safety of her car, flung open the door, and a coyote had somehow gotten locked inside. But the damaged interior was covered thanks to Farmers Insurance. Coyote Carpool, August 1st, 2015. Talk to a Farmers agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are Farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Toro's forward, Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your local's Farmers agent at 701-838-8144.
Hey guys, my name is Steve Olschwanger, fire chief from Maryland Heights, Missouri. I love Firehouse Subs because you can feed your whole crew and help your community thanks to Firehouse Subs Catering. If you're planning a tailgate, an office holiday party, or anything in between, Firehouse Subs has crowd-pleasing platters starting at just $5 per person. They'll even deliver to you. And of course, you'll be helping your community because a portion of every purchase at Firehouse Subs goes towards helping first responders in our communities. The more subs folks enjoy, the more Firehouse Subs is able to help save lives.
Firehouse Subs Catering. Choose from sub, salad, or dessert platters for your next group gathering. Platters start at just $5 a person. Visit firehousesubs.com to find a location near you. Firehouse Subs, founded by firemen. Firehouse of America will donate 0.13% of your purchases in 2017 at all U.S. locations to the Firehouse Subs Public Safety Foundation with a minimum donation of $1 million. For full details, visit firehousesubs.com.
You're gonna love fire from Ryan.
Hi, this is Carson Wentz. While we have a couple seconds, I'd like to tell you why I'm a fan of Ryan Family Dealerships. They know the only way to win someone's respect, to earn their business, is by meeting and exceeding their expectations. That's why I buy my vehicles here. Whether it's sales, parts, or service, you can be sure they'll go the extra mile for you. Take it from me, you're gonna love buying from Ryan.
Your hands are a vital part of who you are, how you work, play, even how you communicate. When injury or illness strikes, the hand team at Trinity Health will be there to help restore full functionality. We specialize in surgical repairs, hand reconstruction, non-surgical interventions, and occupational therapies. Don't let damage or disorder take away your hands. See the hand team at Trinity Health. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
Hi, Taros fans. I'm Colby Enns. When the Taros get on the bus, the first stop is always at Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Taros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much, we eat at the Minot location, too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at libertytax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
All in one place, you can get a fabulous coffee, the best burger in town, arrange a meeting for up to 30 people, and begin your next trip, whether business or vacation. It's Minot's newest, most architecturally beautiful, versatile structure, the Minot International Airport. The Trestle Tap House and Cafe with Caribou Coffee and customizable meeting spaces are just a couple of the amenities offered. The Minot International Airport. See the world from home.
Captain's Cove Seafood Restaurant invites you in for your favorite seafood as well as steak, chicken, and lots of great burgers and sandwiches. The Cove has fish and chips, crab, shrimp, and all-you-can-eat meals. Captain's Cove, where fishing is made easy. 1735 South Broadway in Minot.
Throughout the areas we serve, First International Bank and Trust employees are actively involved in helping our customers and communities grow. This is Kevin Vigestead from First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Whether it's coaching a Little League team, leading through involvement with nonprofit organizations, or a proud Beaver booster, know that all of us at First International Bank and Trust are committed to giving back to the places where we live and work.
I'm here at the year's hottest stag pool party.
Put your antlers up!
Where? Some poor guy's backyard. These stags are bringing down the house. Seriously, deer are ripping holes in the pool cover. They're trampling patio furniture.
And all the damage was covered, thanks to Farmers Insurance. Stag Pool Party, October 27th, 2014. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Taros Forward Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your locals farmer's agent at...
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena. We'll take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard here on the Minotauros Network. Brad, I don't think it's gotten any prettier in Austin. Actually, it has. Bobcats got one more, so they're late in the second. It's now 4-2. Philly 2-1 over Johnstown. That one's mid-third. Late in the third, Northeast and New Jersey are even at aces. Cooley a 1-0 lead on Springfield. The Jets lead the Magicians 3-0. 4-2, as I mentioned, in Austin. Bruins over the Bobcats. 4-2 in Topeka, where the Bulls lead the Roadrunners. Odessa 1-0 over Shreveport. And, of course, here it is scoreless. Take a look at the NHL board.
A busy final night in the National Hockey League. Midway through the third, the Jets lead the Blackhawks 4-1. Boston up on Ottawa midway through the third, also 3-2. Just underway in the third, Toronto over Montreal 2-1. 5 minutes to go in the third, Detroit over the Islanders 3-2. The Panthers in a very important game, basically a do or die for them. And they need help along the way. Midway through the third, they're up on the Sabres 3-0.
Helps to get the Sabres on a must-win night.
Yeah. Washington is leading the Devils 5-3 midway through the third. Also midway through the third, Carolina up on Tampa 2-1. Nashville taking care of business in Columbus tonight, 3-0, and that's 17 to go in the second. Just actually underway, Anaheim and Arizona are 0-0 in a very important game. St. Louis and Colorado are tied 0-0 midway through the first. Late tonight, the final games of the season, Vegas in Calgary, Vancouver in Edmonton, Dallas in L.A., Minnesota in San Jose, and one final earlier today as the Flyers beat the Rangers 5-0.
And Brad, I know last night we talked about the end of the era in Vancouver. The Sundins played their final home game last night. You know, for me growing up in Chicago, Patrick Sharp played his last home game for the Blackhawks, and certainly not the caliber of player as the Sundins, but a very good player for a very long time in Chicago. And actually, you know, he's probably was my favorite Blackhawk during the run just because he was there in the dark ages.
Yeah.
He started in Chicago in 2005 before Kane and Taze, and back when I was going to games in college and there were, you know, 6,000 people in the building. So to be able to see him get his last home game last night and get the recognition I thought he deserved, as he was a huge part of that turnaround in Chicago. So, as just a Blackhawks fan, it was nice to see. And that is the hard part about the end of the season at any level is, you know, we're looking here, and fortunately we made the playoffs, but for a handful of 20-year-olds on our roster, this was their last regular season game tonight. For guys at every level of the game, you know, that end of the year, there's some guys who it's their last meaningful game, whether you're playing your last junior game or your last college game or your last NHL game or last minor pro game. You kind of, when you get to that end of the line, it's hard. And, thank goodness we made the playoffs and these guys get a few more.
Well, hopefully it's quite a few more. And, we probably hashed over last year's playoff disappointment way too many times, and hopefully we can turn the tides here as both teams enter in the exact opposite way we did last year. We walked into the playoffs last year being the number one team in the division and lost a series to Aberdeen 3-1 that really wasn't that close, even though the games were somewhat close, I guess. But
yeah. The Toros' only win was the 7-1 blowout. Yeah.
But the other three losses, it didn't seem like the Toros were generating any offense, and seemed very disappointing. So hopefully we can write a new script next week when we head down to Aberdeen.
That'll do it for the Farmers Union Insurance intermission report. You'll have the second intermission report, at least the first half, solo, as I'll be down on the ice, hopefully giving away $5,000. So that should be fun.
Yeah.
But we'll be back after a commercial break here with the start of the second period here on the Minotauros Network.
Hey guys, my name is Steve Olschwanger, Fire Chief from Maryland Heights, Missouri, and I love Firehouse Subs. Take their meatball sub, for example. It's loaded wall-to-wall with Italian meatballs and a zesty marinara with melted provolone on a toasted roll. And when I say take their meatball sub, I mean it. Grab a medium meatball sub combo to go right now, just $6. But don't forget, the reason Firehouse Subs is driven to make the best subs anywhere is simple. The more subs you enjoy, the more they're able to help save lives, because a portion of every purchase goes towards first responders in our communities.
The Firehouse Sub Meatball Sub Combo. Medium meatball sub, your choice of chips and a 22-ounce drink. Get it hot and ready in our to-go box, now just $6 for a limited time only. Order online now at firehousesubs.com. Firehouse Subs, founded by firemen. Firehouse of America will donate 0.13% of your purchases in 2017 at all U.S. locations to the Firehouse Subs Public Safety Foundation, with a minimum donation of $1 million. For full details, visit firehousesubs.com.
Hi, Toros fans. I'm Alex Adams. When the Toros get on the bus, the first stop is always Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Toros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much, we eat at the Minot location too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for $20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Take care of your feet, and they'll take care of you. The foot and ankle specialists at Trinity Health can help with both surgical and non-surgical solutions. So patients who suffer from foot and ankle related issues can say, so long heel pain, catch you later corns, hasta la vista hammer toes. Relieve pain now and help prevent future discomfort. Diagnosis and treatment is available today. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
We live in such a fast-paced world. It's always go, go, go. When I'm out for a run, it's my time. It's the best way to start your day. Crossing the line of that marathon, it's the biggest reward you can get. I want my customers to achieve their goals and go above and beyond. I'm Nikki Ledeggi, and I'm one of the running experts at Shields.
Shields, when it comes to gear and expert advice, we're right there with you in Bismarck, Minot, Grand Forks, Fargo, and Moorhead.
Hello, I'm Steve Funningsland, consumer lender at First Western Bank and Trust and sports enthusiast. Employees at First Western know the importance of teamwork and their day-to-day banking duties to best serve the community. I know the Minot and surrounding area high school and college athletic teams know the importance of teamwork as well. We want to wish all local teams good luck in their athletic endeavors this year. Stay safe on the courts, on the fields, on the rinks, and in the gyms. We look forward to watching you succeed. With familiar faces you know, who know you by name, First Western Bank and Trust, you can bank on us, member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena as we get ready to start period number two between the Toros and the Aberdeen Wings. Toros and Wings are scoreless. Wings out shooting the Toros 10-8 through the first 20 minutes. At this point, Brad, forget final scores. You don't have a real goal against these guys yet this weekend. The one that went in last weekend was a fluky bounce off the end boards.
And, you know, as much as I think we had a decent period. That period, we really didn't have a lot of scoring opportunities.
No.
And that's the problem we had early in the season with these guys and last year in the playoffs was they held us to the perimeter and didn't give us a lot of scoring chances.
Draw eventually controlled by Fritz Belisle. He'll dump it cross corner. I thought he was short of center, but they wave it off into the near wall. It comes. Murphy spins towards the middle. Riley Murphy chips into the far side. Toros look to chase after. Played down low. This is Enns. Enns up the middle. He finds Belisle at the red line. Belisle carries into the zone. Looks to center it. Hops on Pavel. And Fletcher looks to turn. Three on two. Fletcher leaves for Burke. Burke into the middle. Shot fought off by Lonkula. Kept at the point by Weigel. Shot blocked by Pavel. Weigel lays across. Up top, Britt. Britt puts to the side of the net. Fletcher fans on it. Murphy gets a good whack, but Samu's up to the task. This is Weigel. Long shot through traffic. Blocked out front by Pavel. Weigel throws one up and over the cage. Just me, or does Samu look a little uncomfortable after that last save? Far side, it's played down the wall.
Don't say that again.
The way he went after the shot after it, he didn't look okay, but now he looks to be fine. This is carried ahead. Bendorf into the zone, looks to center, blocked off by Rosenbaum. Taken away, Loven chips ahead for Adams. Adams finds Mucha. Mooch gains the line, delays, plays it down low. Adams tied up, lets it roll to Loven. Loven walking out of the corner, finds Mucha, shot, crossbar! Up top for Earn. Earn comes back down to Mooch. Mooch fans on that shot. Mikowski finds it, plays ahead, he missed Sicoli. Kolick back to Earn. Earn delays, looks up the middle, that was behind Alex Adams, and onto the stick of Kelly. Far side, Kolick plays the body, that frees it up for Mucha, looks into the middle, that missed Adams, Loven will look to chase it in the corner, he'll get there first. He's tied up, however, Kelly and Adams come together again. Two captains, both wearing number 8 for their teams. Now they battle in behind the net, Mooch trying to dig it out, he finds it. Miro. Walking out of the corner, plays up top to Lincoln Earn. Earn sweeps across to the far point. Kolick shot, save made, rebound loose, and Mikowski did well to put it back under his goaltender as that was laying loose in the blue paint.
You know, one thing I have noticed tonight, more than I guess in previous games, is the length of shifts tonight for the Toros have been way long.
They have been.
And not just that first line that was just caught out there for quite some time, but
as
up
a
and
whole,
down, up and down, up and
they've
down.
Been yep. out there for longer than that golden 45 seconds where you're on and off and you're fresh and you're rolling them.
And they certainly haven't been because they've been in one zone or the other. There's been up and downs.
Yeah, it just seems like they're staying out too long.
Centering feed, Dolomer missed. He had room on the top corner, but he put it up off the glass. Centering feed, Dolomer spins that one wide. Rebound to the near side, Lance. Looks down the wall, Earn skips one on net. Speaking of, that defense pair stayed out. Now a nice tip out front by Brian Adams, but a save by Vinyl. .1706 left to play in period two. Toros have four shots on goal already this period. Now even with the Wings, 12-12.
Another thing I thought we'd see a little bit more of is, we talked about it last night, putting Pavel on against the Strada line and matching that lineup.
Near side. I think the Pavel line pretty much shut them down in Aberdeen as that goes for an icing. That was way early. I mean, Kimball won the race, but they blew the whistle before that puck crossed the goal line, or icing line, I guess.
They do that quite frequently, Ken.
That is the downside
But if Pavel line shut down Strada,
I think they'll go back to that matchup in the playoffs, I think.
But why not make his life hard now?
It seems to me like they're just rolling the lines right now. They're not playing matchup hockey. And this is Pitters into the zone. Drops for Strada back to Pitters. Centering feed. Stopped by Lonkala.
Saved by Lonkala.
.1645 left to go in period number two.
Now this is good, Ken. Toro's equipment manager has come in on prom night with his date. These guys got their priorities straight.
I like it. Weigel, his shot goes wide. Out to neutral ice. Fanning on it was Kangas. It seems to happen every year. We end up playing at home at prom, and we end up seeing three or four couples who decide to blow off the dance and come to the game. I mean, if that's your plan, that's fine. I just don't go why you spend the money for the dress and the suit or the tux.
Yeah.
Big hit on the far side, and Spencer Kimball's hurt.
Yeah, and you better get into the bench quick.
Marty Murray is livid, but Kimball able to get up on his own.
Is there a reason why our trainer did not come out onto the ice?
You know,
I mean, how long did he have to lay there?
Unfortunately, Jess Rundell is out this weekend. She's the usual trainer provided by Trinity, and she, unfortunately, I believe her grandmother is in the hospital, so we, of course, send thoughts and prayers that way. But that's a fill-in trainer. And perhaps he's not as used to the duties as Jess is. Up to the near side, Rosenbaum finds Belial. Nice pass through the neutral zone. Belial's shot's gloved and held by Vinyl.
Good play, Pavel. Way to get in there.
Pavel dumps Sinard on top of his own goaltender.
I think that's excellent, especially after Kimball just takes a shot on a no call.
.1548 left to go here in the second. Still looking for the game's first goal. Pavel and Burke tie up on the draw. Belial digs it out, tries a shot, tip play. They had Green driving the front, but he was hauled down. Belial touches it into the middle. It's hacked away, and the Wings will look to counter. This is Fletcher. Fletcher poked free, and that was offside. That could also be why. Perhaps they've decided to try Pavel against the Burke line.
And that could be. That could be.
Pavel just gave Fletcher a shot, too. It's good. That's good. Let Aberdeen push us around.
15:33 left to go here in the second. Sokoli and Lovin. Lovin wins the draw back quickly, D to D for the Toros. Pass up the middle, finds Lovin splitting the D. Shot save made, rebound, and Adams.
Oh, he's getting. Kelly is just all over him.
Now a backhand feed across. Adams couldn't find that. Mooch, now a shot. Was that blocked by Bendorf's helmet as he was falling?
I don't know what it hit.
This is far side. Cook gets hit hard by Alex Adams. They play up top to Earn. Earn, shot, tip goes up and over. The rebound caught the glass and jumped over everyone and now starts the wings the other way. Bendorf in behind the defense. Didn't catch it cleanly, and now a shot that was tipped off the glove of Samu Lankula. This would be a delayed offside. Mikowski ahead for Bendorf. Touched up the middle. Weigel. Weigel gains the line. Looks to walk in. Shot goes wide.
Didn't miss by much, Ken.
Hitters finds the rebound on the far side. Kolick steps into him. It's guided back to the point. Rahowiak plays back to Weigel. Weigel. Shot looking for a tip from Strada. It went up off the glass. And Lovin just put down Strada very hard. That was more head contact than the hit that was called head contact earlier.
Well, the one that wasn't a hit?
Yeah.
And again, it's amped up a little bit in the intensity.
It certainly has.
And this scoring chances have increased too. Funny how that works, Dan.
Dangerously close to too many men, and now Brian Adams wins a battle in behind the net. Brian Adams banks back to the point. Kimball kept it, apparently. Now he comes across Adams. Adams shot, gloved, and held. Boy, I like the way this Adams kid plays.
I do too.
13:57 left to go in period number two. Shots now 14-13 in favor of the Toros. What's the discussion here? Good news for the Toros. Spencer Kimball didn't miss a shift. I think they're telling both benches to maybe tone it down. I don't know why.
Okay, we don't want exciting physical hockey.
I haven't seen anything particularly
dirty.
Yeah.
Except for the hit on Kimball when he didn't have the puck.
Now Dolomer gets tossed from the draw, so Lance will step in. Lance wins it back. Kimball.
Oh, my God.
Strada takes that away. Lankula out of his net, just throws it to the near side. Big hit on the near side. Dolomer keeps it.
He's got
Lance going to the middle, but he can't get it there. Defended nicely by Sinard because Lance was all alone. But Sinard just never gave Dolly a lane. This is Sinard. Plays it to the near side. It's out to neutral ice. Rahowiak watched by Spencer Kimball. A shot. That goes wide, and Strada finds it in the near corner. He gets put down, but Sinard keeps it. Shot blocked by Dolomer. Heward's shot's blocked, but he gets it back. Long shot. This one skips wide. Dolomer will find it. Dolly hits the brakes, holds, and looks across for Spencer Kimball. Kimball gains the line and rings it deep. Dolomer gives chase. Weigel's there. Weigel lets Dolomer get it. And Dolly plays it across the far side. Bauer with a big hit on Heward. Puck squirts free. Pitters plays ahead for Strada. Strada found Pitters streaking through the middle. Pitters has it taken away as he went against a trio of Toros. Bauer ahead, gains the line. Bauer, he's bumped hard, walks right through it, trying to drive the front. He gets thrown onto the back of the net for a whistle. Bauer and Logan Britt both laughing about it.
Where are they going to face this off at?
Looks like it'll be in the offensive zone. Once they get the net back on the pegs. Draw will be to the left of Vinyl. Ness wins it back cleanly. McGinnis chips it deep. It'll roll to the far side. Britt and Ness tie up. Bauer's there. Ness has it poked free, gets it back, sweeps it back to the point. Rosenbaum chips it down low for Bauer. Bauer lost the battle to Weigel. Kangas steps in, frees it up. It's swept along the near side. McGinnis pinches down from the point. Keeps it down the wall into the middle. That missed. Ness and the Toros will have to retreat and retrieve. 12-10 left to go here in the second. Still looking for the game's first goal. Banked ahead. Kangas touches for Ness. Ness for Rosenbaum. Rosenbaum gains the line but lost the handle. Ness did well to keep it at the point. They dig along the wall. Kangas works it down low. Ness now with one hand on the stick using his body to protect. Now Kangas dangerously close to a bad hit. Now shot by the Lyle. That's the second crossbar the Toros have hit tonight. It was Mooch, I believe, who had the other.
Yep.
Weigel ahead for Walker. Walker gains the line. Far side. Murphy takes Rosenbaum down. Pavel steps in and wins the puck. Burke kept it alive and then plays down to Murphy. Murphy watched by Lincoln Earn trying to drive the net. Wraparound try. That's shut down by Rosenbaum. Murphy still has it, though. And then he gets dumped down. Fletcher in support finds it. Comes across for Mikowski. Mikowski's long shot blocked out front by Lincoln Earn. Banked ahead. That got past Mikowski.
It hit a stick.
But there won't be icing. Kelly's back on it. Belial had him lined up. He turns away from the hit and throws it up the near side wall. Finds Murphy. Murphy watched by Enns. Looks to center. It's broken up. Taken away by Kimball. Kimball leaves in the near corner for Enns. Enns keeps it moving for Pavel. Pavel gains the line. Squeezes past Mikowski but can't chase it down. He gets it back. Pavel hits the brakes. Wants to center. Has nothing, so he plays back to Colby Enns. Enns shots tipped out front. Bouncing puck to the side of the net. Green can't corral. Then he's pushed into the glass by Kelly. Good whack by Green on Kelly in retaliation.
Kelly's a strong defenseman.
This is Green trying to guide it back to the point. Now Kelly steps in. Pavel. Pavel lost it, and it's out to neutral ice. Bendorf into the middle for Burke. It was off the mark. Mucha steps in. Carried ahead by Enns. Finds Mucha. Miro gains the line. He'll ring it in behind the net. Toros are mid-change. There was no help coming. That's thrown up ice. It'll go for icing if Lincoln Earn can win the race, and he does. 9:41 left to go here in the second. We're still scoreless. Draw will be to the right of Vinyl. Draw one back by the Toros. Earn keeps it by punching it down low to the Papa Murphy Zamdor. Eventually taken away from Alex Adams, though, and played to the near side. Bendorf. Bendorf ahead finds Sladek. Sladek looking into the middle. He wanted a tip from Sokoli. Didn't get one. Alex Adams finds it and plays it back for Kolek. 9:20 to go here in the period as Kolek tries to come out from behind. Works it ahead, but it's taken back by the wings. Sinard in a scoreless game starts up the near side. His dump in hits his own man Bendorf at the blue line, allowing the Toros to take over. Earn has trouble, but eventually gets it to Alex Adams, who goes back across the ice for Kolek. Kolek gains the red line and dumps it to the near side corner. Loven chases after, but Vinyl stopped it for Sinard. Sinard plays across for Britt. Britt comes back to the near circle, and Sinard, his pass hits the referee in the skates, but still ends up on Pitter's tape.
Offsides.
Pitters is bumped off by Rosenbaum. The puck rolls around to the far side. Brian Adams tied up there. McGinnis works it ahead. Lance flicks it for Dollimer. It was out of his reach. Dolly races and manages to keep it on side for Lance. Lance looking across. He had the late man McGinnis, but the pass was just out of his reach. Toro's regrouping in unclaimed ice. Rosenbaum drops back to McGinnis. They continue to backpedal into their own zone. Back around to the near side for Rosenbaum. Keeps it away from Strada. It's ahead. Dollimer played that with a high stick. And on the touch by Adams, the whistle goes. Draw will be in front of the visiting penalty box. 8:17 left to go here in period number two. of a scoreless game. For team 13, the shots on goal, and Brad, again, you've done everything but score, I think, in this one. The guys you wanted to see look good who were returning from injury this weekend have looked good. Samu, of course, has been fantastic. He's seen 53 shots this weekend and stopped all but two.
I would just like to see one go in the net here so we can get some confidence that the puck does go in the net, and we should be good.
You know, I didn't redo the numbers before this weekend, but Gabe Vinyl has had himself a pretty good season. A 9.15 save percentage and a 2.27 goals against average.
He's been good against the Toros.
That's what I was going to say. His numbers against the Toros are unreal.
He's 5-1. He's at a 1.83, .936 save percentage.
So, shot on, save made. When you take the Toros games out of his numbers, he's actually had a pretty average to even maybe not great season. But he's been unbelievable against the Toros. I think it's still like a respectable like 906 or something last I looked when you take out Toros games. Strada looks across for Pitters. Shot on, save made. Strada finds it and puts it wide of the cage. Backdoor pass, that's blocked off. Mikowski keeps it. Mikowski down for Strada, back to Mikowski. One timer, save made. Rebound loose in the slot. Toros can't clear it out. Drop down low. This is the Toros' fourth line, Ness, Bauer, and Kangas, and now a shot on that's gloved and held by Lankala for a whistle. Why of all guys on the ice for the Toros, is Spencer Kimball the one that the Wings seem to be trying to
abuse?
Yes.
I don't know. Let's drew his name out of the hat, but he's probably one that would just not even, you know.
No offense to Spencer Kimball, but
no.
He's a defenseman with no goals and 5 assists on the season and a minus 7. I can't imagine he's the guy you want to
target,
knock out of a playoff series. This is Burke in, leaves off far side. Fletcher shot, save made, and the rebound is covered. And I don't mean that as a criticism of Spencer Kimball. I just, if you're going to pull up a roster and say, who's the guy we need to abuse this weekend and
that's not
have
the guy
Hardy going into the playoffs, it's...
I'm not picking him.
Draw one by the Wings. What do we got?
Kicked it. He kicked the puck back.
The first one's a warning, the second one's a penalty, I believe. So Spencer now on the draw, 7-11 left to go here in the middle stanza. Toro's control, Kalik. Ahead, Green plays back to Earn. Earn finds Kalik. Kalik, toss across, finds Green. Green, shot, save made. Rebound given to the far side. Belial plays back to the point. Kalik's long shot, that's tipped wide. Spencer finds it, banks across to the far side. Britt will get there first. Belial with a good shoulder into him. It's kept onside only for a moment as the Wings take over and Weigel has room. Ahead for Weigel. Gains the line on the near side. Weigel looking to center, broken up by Lincoln Earn. Pavel finds it. Pavel, toss across, finds Green.
Boy, he got his stick hacked out of his...
Who was that? It was behind the play.
Pavel made that pass, and he got his stick hacked out of his hands.
They dig on the near side. Lovin. Lovin. Working against a pair of Wings, and he wins the battle. Only for a moment, now another scrum. Lovin frees it up, Mucha couldn't gather. And it's chipped out to neutral ice. Touch to the near side, Alex Adams gains the line. Al Lost the handle, though, so now we'll just bring it deep for Rosenbaum. Rosenbaum's pinned there. Weigel finds it. Weigel ahead to Bendorf. He'll work on Alex Adams, who was watching Rosenbaum's point. A centering feed is broken up by McGinnis. McGinnis looks ahead for Mucha. Miro didn't catch that cleanly, and now we'll have to scrum for it on the far side. Bendorf touches ahead for Sladek. Down low, Sladek. They kick it along. Spun to the near side. Adams.
Well, Adams and Muha have been out there for 2.5 minutes now.
Shot on, save made by Lonkola. Sladek finds it. 4:42 left in the period. Centering feed fought off by Lonkola on the one-timer by Sladek. McGinnis holds behind the net, tries the far side in Mucha.
We need a change so bad.
Miro trying to find Adams, but the pass was behind him. Mikowski gains the line, sends one in. Rahowiak on the far side, plays down the wall. The Wings control in their own zone. Lance picks that off. Looks in the middle for Dolomer. Dolomer shot off the tip of the glove. Brian Adams in behind. Oh, he's taken down. And the Toros will go to the power play with 4:07 left to go. Some pushing and shoving now.
Now Dolomer's going too. For the retaliation, he's going. So we just took ourselves a power play away. And he didn't even get his money's worth.
Two minutes for boarding, 2 minutes for roughing.
Should be four
roughing,
on four.
Boarding, yeah, so it'll be 4-on-4.
Should be, but I want to bet it's not.
Penalties first to Charles, skater number 12, Austin Dolomer. 2 minutes.
So we'll go for a side.
Penalty also down 8, skater number 16.
Drawn to the right of Vinyl. Pitters and Pavel. Swept along in behind, it's Joey Strada. Belial, Pavel, Kimball, and Enns, the quartet. Out for the Toros to start the 4-on-4. Dalton Weigel ahead for the Wings. Plays back to Sinard. Sinard didn't catch it cleanly. Now we'll just chip it into the zone. Lonkola out of his net. Turns it over. Cleaned up nicely by Colby Enns. Spencer Kimball. Enns touches to the near side. Pavel gathers it in. Andre Pavel looking to attack. Drags right through the defender. Wraparound try. Did he stop? Did he stop? It was right on the goal line as they hacked.
Well, where's the puck?
The referee was right over top. It was really close. I don't think it ever completely crossed the line. .122 left in the man advantage.
Can you remind the finalists to go to merch?
Draw controlled by the Wings. This is Burke.
Offsides.
Bendorf didn't get back.
Yes, that were drawn in the first period. Don't forget to report to the merchandise area with 2 minutes remaining. Report to the merchandise area, please.
Draw controlled by the Toros. Battle in the corner and penalty coming. So, Adams goes, and the Toros will be shorthanded. It's a 4-on-3 power play for the Wings for 58 seconds. Then it'll go to a 4-on-5.
Should be a 4-on-3. Which I would rather have than a 5-on-4, because you don't work on 4-on-3 as much.
Yeah, but there's so much more open ice. This is controlled by the Wings off the draw. Fletcher, if he had turned, he had a clean lane to drive the net. Fortunately, he gave the puck up. This is Strada. Strada up top for Britt. Britt back for Strada. Strada, side of the net. For Fletcher. Fletcher gives back to Strada at the hash marks. 39 seconds left in the 4-on-3. And now Pav takes it away. Pavel looking to go shorthanded. Pav delays. Now he'll wisely just take it into the corner and eat it. Eventually dug out by Burke. 22 seconds left in the 4-on-3. Pass for Strada was too long for him. Hammered along the near side. This is Britt. Keeps it at the point, walks to the middle. Pav takes away the lane and gives it up to Strada. Strada, shot. That was blocked by his own guy, and now Burke couldn't tuck it home. Fletcher getting worked over by Colby Enns in front of the net. One-time try coming, blockered away. Dolomer out of the box. He'll step
oh,
it away.
Oh, he could have railed Britt there.
Instead, he just sends it all the way down. I don't mind just taking the puck away and sending it 200 feet.
Ken, you always take the easy way.
You don't want to be down 5-on-3.
I don't know that he would have been.
These officiating crews.
He had the puck.
Spencer Kimball didn't and got railroaded. This is Weigel up top for Pitters. Centering feed, tacked a tape for Sicoli, and then he drops it back to Weigel. Just saying, sometimes they call the carnage more than the actual contact. Now a shot kicked away by Lankala, and Loven pokes it to the near wall. Just 10 seconds left on the power play. Weigel across. Shot coming through traffic is gloved and held by Lankala. 4 seconds left. On the power play. Draw will be to the left of Lankala. 1,908 fans enjoying a scoreless game thus far here at the Mesa Arena. Draw controlled by the Wings. Adams comes out of the box. Fletcher in the slot. Shot. That's blocked off by traffic. I don't know that Lankala was able to see that. He was down low trying to see through the screen as we hit the final minute of play in the second period. Shot blocked by Lincoln Earn. Ahead, Adams manages to touch that out to neutral ice. This is Kelly spinning it back. Mikowski. Ahead for Fletcher. Fletcher couldn't pull the trigger. Fletcher gives it back, looks across. Kelly couldn't hold it. This is Mikowski, shot blocked. And the puck rolls out to neutral. Final 10 seconds of the period. Wings control. Big hit by Ness on Mikowski. Pitters is in. Shot save made. Rebound to the corner. The horn sounds. We're through two.
Once again, fans that were drawn in the first period from the special drawing, please make sure you report to the merchandise area.
That'll do it for period number two. When Brad comes back. He'll take you around the hockey world. And I'll be back for the second half of the intermission, hopefully. We'll be back after these messages here on the Minotauros Network.
Hi, Tauros fans. I'm Colby Enns. When the Tauros get on the bus, the first stop is always at Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Tauros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much, we eat at the Minot location, too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at libertytax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
All in one place, you can get a fabulous coffee, the best burger in town. Arrange a meeting for up to 30 people and begin your next trip, whether business or vacation. It's Minot's newest, most architecturally beautiful, versatile structure, the Minot International Airport. The Trestle Tap House and Cafe with caribou coffee and customizable meeting spaces are just a couple of the amenities offered. The Minot International Airport. See the world from home.
Captain's Cove Seafood Restaurant invites you in for your favorite seafood as well as steak, chicken, and lots of great burgers and sandwiches. The Cove has fish and chips, crab, shrimp, and all-you-can-eat meals. Captain's Cove, where fishing is made easy. 1735 South Broadway in Minot.
Throughout the areas we serve, First International Bank and Trust employees are actively involved in helping our customers and communities grow. This is Kevin Vigestead from First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Whether it's coaching a little league team, leading through involvement with nonprofit organizations, or a proud Beaver booster, know that all of us at First International Bank and Trust are committed to giving back to the places where we live and work.
I'm here at the year's hottest stag pool party.
Put your antlers up!
Where? Some poor guy's backyard. These stags are bringing down the house. Seriously, deer are ripping holes in the pool cover. They're trampling patio furniture.
And all the damage was covered, thanks to Farmers Insurance. Stag Pool Party, October 27th, 2014. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Tauros forward Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your local farmer's agent at 701-838-8144.
Hey guys, my name is Steve Olschwanger, fire chief from Maryland Heights, Missouri, and I love Firehouse Subs. Take their meatball sub, for example. It's loaded wall-to-wall with Italian meatballs and a zesty marinara with melted provolone on a toasted roll. And when I say take their meatball sub, I mean it. Grab a medium meatball sub combo to go right now, just $6. But don't forget, the reason Firehouse Subs is driven to make the best subs anywhere is simple. The more subs you enjoy, the more they're able to help save lives because a portion of every purchase goes towards first responders in our communities.
The Firehouse Sub Meatball Sub Combo. Medium meatball sub, your choice of chips and a 22-ounce drink. Get it hot and ready in our to-go box, now just $6 for a limited time only. Order online now at firehousesubs.com. Firehouse Subs, founded by firemen. Firehouse of America will donate 0.13% of your purchases in 2017 at all U.S. locations to the Firehouse Subs Public Safety Foundation with a minimum donation of $1 million. For full details, visit firehousesubs.com.
Hi, Tauros fans. I'm Alex Adams. When the Tauros get on the bus, the first stop is always Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Tauros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much, we eat at the Minot location, too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Take care of your feet, and they'll take care of you. The foot and ankle specialists at Trinity Health can help with both surgical and non-surgical solutions. So, patients who suffer from foot and ankle-related issues can say, so long heel pain, catch you later corns, hasta la vista hammer toes. Relieve pain now and help prevent future discomfort. Diagnosis and treatment is available today. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
We live in such a fast-paced world. It's always go, go, go. When I'm out for a run, it's my time. It's the best way to start your day. Crossing the line of that marathon, it's the biggest reward you can get. I want my customers to achieve their goals and go above and beyond. I'm Nikki Ledeggi, and I'm one of the running experts at Shields.
Shields, when it comes to gear and expert advice, we're right there with you in Bismarck, Minot, Grand Forks, Fargo, and Moorhead.
Hello, I'm Steve Funningsland, consumer lender at First Western Bank and Trust and sports enthusiast. Employees at First Western know the importance of teamwork in their day-to-day banking duties to best serve the community. I know the Minot and surrounding area high school and college athletic teams know the importance of teamwork as well. We want to wish all local teams good luck in their athletic endeavors this year. Stay safe on the courts, on the fields, on the rinks, and in the gyms. We look forward to watching you succeed. With familiar faces you know, who know you by name, First Western Bank and Trust, you can bank on us, member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
All in one place, you can get a fabulous coffee, the best burger in town, arrange a meeting for up to 30 people, and begin your next trip, whether business or vacation. It's Minot's newest, most architecturally beautiful, versatile structure, the Minot International Airport. The Trestle Tap House and Cafe with Caribou Coffee and customizable meeting spaces are just a couple of the amenities offered. The Minot International Airport. See the world from home.
Hi, Taros fans. I'm Lincoln Earn. When the Taros are on the road, we always stop at Applebee's. They always take care of the Taros, giving us the fuel we need to win away from the Mesa. The boys love to eat there after home games, too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Daniel the Deer danced everywhere. He pranced through fields and jigged through rivers. Then he saw it. What a stage! A place no deer had dared dance before. The hood of a brand new car.
Hey, my car!
And the car was covered, thanks to Farmers Insurance. Deer Dance Floor, December 1st, 2014. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Charles Forward, Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your local's farmer's agent at 701-838-8144.
Welcome back to the Pepsi Rink. Well, we're in our second intermission between the Minot Minotauros and the Aberdeen Wings, and we're still knotted at zero. Shots after two, 22-16 in favor of the Wings, and what's been a pretty back-and-forth, equally played period of hockey, and both these teams will be meeting each other next week in the playoffs, so a pretty good feeler. Both teams a little bit playing, I guess, a little bit conservative, but things got a little bit more intense in the second period. And some more scoring opportunities was a result of that. Let's take a quick spin around the North American Hockey League on the final night of regular season play. The game final, Philadelphia beats Johnstown 3-1. Northeast beats New Jersey 2-1. Just final, Cooley Region is upended by Springfield 3-2. Janesville over the Minnesota Magicians 4-0. With 7 minutes to go in the third, Austin leads the Bismarck Bobcats 5-2. So Austin will get that second spot, barring a complete failure here in the last 7 minutes. And we'll have home ice advantage over the Minnesota Wilderness for the first round of the playoffs, which begin next Friday night. So the Central Region will be Minnesota Wilderness in Austin for Game 1. And the Aberdeen Wings will host the Minot Minotauros in Game 1 of the semifinals of the Central Division. Couple other games still underway midway through the third. Corpus and Lone Star 0-0. Amarillo over Topeka 5-2 midway through the third. Odessa leads Shreveport 4-0, just about to start that third period. And here in Minot, we are still 0-0. And we'll be starting the third here in about 12 minutes as we have a little bit longer intermission tonight. In the first period, we went through the billets, introduced all the billets, thank them for hosting these young players in their home and how important that is to a junior hockey team. And without the billets, we can't have hockey here in Minot. Second period intermission, we gave away, the Toros gave away a $5,000 grand prize. They also gave a trip for four to Disney World, which was great because a young kid won that one, and that's going to be a great trip of a lifetime and memories for him. Also gave away a hot tub from Hot Springs. So thanks for all the sponsors. And what a great giveaway to the season ticket holders. And thanks to all those season ticket holders, because without them, just like the Billets, we can't have junior hockey here in Minot. 1,900 here in Pepsi tonight. Great crowd again. Another good one. Last night was a good crowd also. And we've been, you know, having good crowds here for the past six games. So the Toros thank everybody that comes out to Mesa Arena. And it's sure, the Pepsi Center has sure been fun this year with bigger crowds and an atmosphere that seems like it keeps amping up every week that we're here. And I can't wait to see what it's like for game three, the following Friday night as we host the Aberdeen Wings in game three.
Brad, I just got back up from giving away a trip to Disneyland.
Yeah, we were just talking about that.
$5,000 cash prize and a hot tub, and you're talking about the atmosphere. This place was loving it. And hopefully, if you're listening here in the Minot area, we're going to be doing the same thing again next year. So get your season tickets. And, you know, we gave away a trip to Vegas earlier this year as well. You know, the season ticket rewards program, some real happy fans tonight.
Yeah, no, it's always fun to see, and it was kind of extra special to see the young kid win the trip to Disney World, and I know I've had my kids there quite a few times, and it's some great memories, so it's fun to see him win that.
It was fun for that, and you know, I'm kind of surprised no one took the offer off the bat.
I'm not.
Really, I personally wouldn't, but I'm a gambler. I
you wouldn't? No, I mean, you're 50-50.
I know, but I bet on...
So what the Toros
I bet on sports all winter long, football, hockey, summer I'm betting on baseball. So I gamble on everything, so I would have gone for it, but I am shocked that at least one of the fans didn't take the guaranteed $500 in season ticket renewals, especially I know a couple of those fans have... Like, the one guy, I think he's got seven kids, and they've got season tickets for the whole family.
Well, that would have been a lot of money.
That would have, you know, but...
But, you know what? You got six boxes. You had three great prizes in there. Three empty boxes. The Toros offered a $500 cash and free tickets for next year, and nobody took...
I love Firehouse Subs, because you can feed your whole crew and help your community, thanks to Firehouse Subs Catering. If you're planning a tailgate, an office holiday party, or anything in between, Firehouse Subs has crowd-pleasing platters starting at just $5 per person. They'll even deliver to you. And of course, you'll be helping your community, because a portion of every purchase at Firehouse Subs goes towards helping first responders in our communities. The more subs folks enjoy, the more Firehouse Subs is able to help save lives.
Firehouse Subs Catering. Choose from sub, salad, or dessert platters for your next group gathering. Platters start at just $5 a person. Visit firehousesubs.com to find a location near you. Firehouse Subs, founded by firemen. Firehouse of America will donate 0.13% of your purchases in 2017 at all U.S. locations to the Firehouse Subs Public Safety Foundation with a minimum donation of $1 million. For full details, visit firehousesubs.com. You're gonna love
fire from Ryan. Hi, this is Carson Wentz. While we have a couple seconds, I'd like to tell you why I'm a fan of Ryan Family Dealerships. They know the only way to win someone's respect, to earn their business, is by meeting and exceeding their expectations. That's why I buy my vehicles here. Whether it's sales, parts, or service, you can be sure they'll go the extra mile for you. Take it from me, you're gonna love buying from Ryan.
Your hands are a vital part of who you are, how you work, play, even how you communicate. When injury or illness strikes, the hand team at Trinity Health will be there to help restore full functionality. We specialize in surgical repairs, hand reconstruction, non-surgical interventions, and occupational therapies. Don't let damage or disorder take away your hands. See the hand team at Trinity Health. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
Hi Toros fans, I'm Colby Innes. When the Toros get on the bus, the first stop is always at Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Toros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much we eat at the Minot location too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for $20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Whoa,
what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at LibertyTax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
All in one place, you can get a fabulous coffee, the best burger in town, arrange a meeting for up to 30 people, and begin your next trip, whether business or vacation. It's Minot's newest, most architecturally beautiful, versatile structure, the Minot International Airport. The Trestle Tap House and Cafe with Caribou Coffee and customizable meeting spaces are just a couple of the amenities offered. The Minot International Airport. See the world from home.
Captain's Cove Seafood Restaurant invites you in for your favorite seafood as well as steak, chicken, and lots of great burgers and sandwiches. The Cove has fish and chips, crab, shrimp, and all-you-can-eat meals. Captain's Cove, where fishing is made easy. 1735 South Broadway in Minot.
Throughout the areas we serve, First International Bank and Trust employees are actively involved in helping our customers and communities grow. This is Kevin Vigestad from First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Whether it's coaching a Little League team, leading through involvement with nonprofit organizations, or a proud Beaver booster, know that all of us at First International Bank and Trust are committed to giving back to the places where we live and work.
I'm here at the year's hottest stag pool party.
Put your antlers up!
Where? Some poor guy's backyard. These stags are bringing down the house. Seriously, deer are ripping holes in the pool cover. They're trampling patio furniture.
And all the damage was covered, thanks to Farmers Insurance. Stag Pool Party, October 27th, 2014. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Toros Forward Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your local farmer's agent at 701-838-8144.
Hey guys, my name is Steve Olschwanger, fire chief from Maryland Heights, Missouri, and I love Firehouse Subs. Take their meatball sub, for example. It's loaded wall-to-wall with Italian meatballs and a zesty marinara with melted provolone on a toasted roll. And when I say take their meatball sub, I mean it. Grab a medium meatball sub combo to go right now, just $6. But don't forget, the reason Firehouse Subs is driven to make the best subs anywhere is simple. The more subs you enjoy, the more they're able to help save lives because a portion of every purchase goes towards first responders and our communities.
The Firehouse Sub Meatball Sub Combo. Medium meatball sub, your choice of chips and a 22-ounce drink. Get it hot and ready in our to-go box, now just $6 for a limited time only. Order online now at firehousesubs.com. Firehouse Subs, founded by firemen. Firehouse of America will donate 0.13% of your purchases in 2017 at all U.S. locations to the Firehouse Subs Public Safety Foundation with a minimum donation of $1 million. For full details, visit firehousesubs.com.
Hi, Toros fans. I'm Alex Adams. When the Toros get on the bus, the first stop is always Applebee's. Whether it's Jamestown, Fargo, or Grand Forks, the Toros always get a good meal. The boys like Applebee's so much, we eat at the Minot location, too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for $20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Take care of your feet, and they'll take care of you. The foot and ankle specialists at Trinity Health can help with both surgical and non-surgical solutions. So patients who suffer from foot and ankle related issues can say, so long heel pain, catch you later corns, hasta la vista hammer toes. Relieve pain now and help prevent future discomfort. Diagnosis and treatment is available today. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
We live in such a fast-paced world. It's always go, go, go. When I'm out for a run, it's my time. It's the best way to start your day. Crossing the line to that marathon, it's the biggest reward you can get. I want my customers to achieve their goals and go above and beyond. I'm Nikki Ledeggi, and I'm one of the running experts at Shields.
Shields, when it comes to gear and expert advice, we're right there with you in Bismarck, Minot, Grand Forks, Fargo, and Moorhead.
Well, Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena as we get ready for the start of period number three. We're looking for our first goal of the night, and it will be the last goal of the North American League hockey season. As, well, maybe not, depending on when it comes. They've still got 12 and a half minutes left in Shreveport, so a quick goal here could potentially have a goal scored after it down in Odessa. Everyone else is approaching the end of their game. 6-3 Austin over Bismarck. That's 13 seconds from going final, so it looks like it will be Aberdeen, Austin, the Wilderness, and then us, the final seeding for the Central Division playoffs. Puck is dropped and we are underway. This is Fletcher. Centering feed is broken up. We are back to 5-on-5 as Britt looks across. Green tried to jump that, and now a tip, and it's in.
High stick.
Burke.
High stick. It's a high stick.
Everyone on the Toro bench.
It's a high stick.
Now the linesman over to talk to him. So the Toros trail 1-0.
That one was so obvious it makes me sick.
You know, we talked about it last night with Lance's goal, though. You want some of that luck to save it for the playoffs.
Horrible officiating isn't luck, Kim.
It is when it goes your way, as that's thrown up and out of play. Draw to the left of Vinyl. Big hit behind the net.
Come on, Adams, fight him.
Adams and Kelly jawing. Far side. Puck to the far side. Rosenbaum steps up and he puts down Bendorf hard. Near side, Sicoli. Lovin steps into him. McGinnis starts up ice. Rolls it deep. Lovin after it. It's chopped out to neutral ice. Brian Adams plays across for Kolick. Long toss ahead finds Brian Adams. Adams has trouble with the referee in his way. And now he gets hit hard, and that's going to draw a call. Adams appears to be fine. Dolomer walks right through. Shot on, save made. And
why is there a whistle? Why is there a whistle? The puck's still in play right in front of the net.
And like you pointed out last night,
every call they got the officials over, or they got Kelly over there complaining about every call.
So Pitters will sit for two, and the Toros will go to the power play.
Penalty to Aberdeen skater number 20, Aaron Pitters. 2 minutes for elbowing. We can sign for another gooseneck implement. Power behind the
Wings control off the draw and ring it to the near side. Touch down the wall for Lance. Lance. His pass hit a leg and it caroms to the far side. Pavel gives chase. Lance frees it up. Dolomer kept it. Dolly bumped off by Kelly. The Toros keep him moving. Lance, he's corralled by Murphy. And is pinched down to keep it alive, and the Toros will set it up. It's up top Rosenbaum. Rosie comes to Dolomer near circle. Dolomer looks up top for Enns. Enns looking for a lane. He thinks he has one. It hit a leg and caromed wide. Dolomer has a stick chopped right out of his hand, and now Sinard looking to go the other way shorthanded. Rosenbaum steps into him. Puck out to neutral ice. Dolomer touches for Lance. Lance gives to Pavel. Pavel gains the line and chips it deep. Vinyl out of his net, plays it onto the far side. It'll be not kept at the point. It hopped on McGinnis. Earn. Starts the Toros up with 50 seconds on the power play. Mucha walks through. Miro has Adams. Shot, save made. Rebound given to the near side. That's one of the rare times I would have liked to see Miro pass that. Adams was all alone on the backside of the play. Lovin swept back to the point and ends. Ends for Earn, back up top, ends. Ends through traffic, save made, rebound. Hacked at, Miro couldn't get it to go. Ends couldn't keep it, Burke stepped in. Left off far side. Toss ahead, finds Alex Adams. Adams chips it into the zone. Lovin gives chase and apparently was offside. 9 seconds left on the Toro power play. Draw at center. One into the wing zone. Ness gains the line, gives to Bauer, back to Ness. Ness puts it across, and Kangas couldn't kick to the stick as the wings come full strength. Thrown down low for Ness. Ness stepped into. Pitters plays ahead. Bauer took it away. The referee just fell down. And that got quite the cheer from the crowd after the blown high stick call.
Kelly is just running people now.
This is chipped down low. Britt. Did you see him try and get Ness as Ness chased after the puck? Meanwhile, Kangas was hooked. Missed a shot wide. Bauer. Ness steps in. Strada can't corral. McGinnis has it now. McGinnis. Dumps it in. Vinyl out of his net to stop. Put it off to the far side. Sinard. Pitters takes it. He'll start up ice. Pitters gains the line on the far side. Earn wins that battle. It's moving to the near side. Pav touches for Belial. Belial's pass across is blocked by Strada. Heward. Up the middle, finds Pitters, gains the line into the middle. Fletcher has his stick checked, so he misses the shot wide. Murphy stepped in too, and it's taken away by Kolick. Kolick continues to impress. Meanwhile, it's ahead for Pavel. Pav looking to attack. It's poked off his stick. Tries a shot anyways, save made with the glove. And now, Heward and Pavel. Heward took a big chop at Pavel's leg. Toro's trail 1-0.
The Toros would like to thank tonight's game sponsor. Tonight's game is being sponsored.
If Gruel doesn't get this under control soon, I think it's going to get silly. ...50-50 draw. Eventually kicks the wall. Fletcher just banks out to neutral ice. Kimball touches for Lance. His pass back to Colby Enns. Missed him. Wankala out of his net. Guides it around to the near corner and Kimball. Kimball plays back behind the net for Enns. Enns for Kimball. Flip back into the Toro zone. Enns is on it. Lance comes across for Kimball. Pass hits a skate. Colby N steps up and finds it. Gains the line. Down the wall. Dolomer throws in front. Lance. Shot blocked in front. And then cleared the length. It'll go for icing as long as Enns wins the race. And he does. 14:06 left to go. draw will be to the right of Vinyl. Draw one by the Toros. Alex Adams looks across. Muha can't kick to the stick, and now a shot blocked off bodies ends up at the end wall. Adams pins a man in the corner. Lovin spinning away, then he lost the handle to Fletcher. Fletcher looks to start up the ice. Lovin catches up with him and hits him hard along the near side.
Now they're going to call it. Yep, might as well call it.
I think he's taking them. Is he taking them both? I don't think it was the initial hit. I think it was when he landed on top of him, he gave him an extra shot.
It's time for another Dr. Jason Bradley and Century Outwear to kill.
So it's a 2-minute rough on Lovin. 13:43 left to go. Draw to the left of Lankawa. One by the wings. It's back to the point. Mikowski back up top. Touched up top. Weigel looks far side. Pitters. Quick shot. Save made by Lankawa. Pav touches it out for Belisle, but it was just a little too long for him. Pitters will gain the line on the far side, hit the brakes, and then roll it deep. Lankawa out of his net, stops it, flicks it along the near side. Sokoli pinched down and kept it alive. Bendorf and McGinnis battle in behind, and then look out. Rosenbaum ripped it into the bench.
Coach Murray went to his belly on that one.
Yeah. Player's having a good laugh.
Still Seth has got a helmet on tonight after getting hit last night.
Draw one back by the wings, but it splits the defense. If you're going to rip a puck into the bench, you're supposed to rip it into the other bench, I thought.
You would think, yeah.
This is Weigel carrying in around Earn centers. He missed on it. Ness clears it. Green chasing down. Kevin Ness getting some PK time. This is Pitters into the zone. Pitters hits the brakes below the goal line. 55 left on the power play. Bendorf. Shot tipped out front by Kolick, who's also out there. So the Toros leaning on the young guys on the PK here. Fletcher. Behind, turning with it. To Pitters. Back up top. Cross for Bendorf. For Britt. Back to Bendorf. In front, tip play. Nice tip by Fletcher. Didn't miss by much.
Just missed.
Back to the point. Britt comes across for Bendorf again. Shot. That one hit Fletcher in the back. Good job by Earn to get it to the wall. And then it's cleared all the way down by Green. Just 7 seconds left on the power play. How about the atmosphere here tonight, Brad, for a game that really doesn't mean a whole heck of a lot?
It's been good. A good crowd.
This one rung around the near side. Molinar down the wall. Ends, hammers it ahead. That's not kept.
Never mind the offsides.
Apparently it was an offside. Fans were all over that one, too. Safe to say this officiating crew might not be the favorite that's come to Minot. Pass ahead. Brian Adams. Broken up at the blue line. It's back to Kimball at the Toros blue line. He goes across for Enns. Enns chips it. Touched for Brian Adams. Adams driving the net. Shot saved, made. Rebound given Adams. Looking into the middle, it's cut off. And going the other way is Walker. Far side, taken away by Strada. Centering feed for Pitters, it missed him. Long shot, that skips wide. Mucha. And that is offside. Side, Adams digging. He's thrown ahead. Earn. Near side. To the far end, Adams. Adams poked away from him. Down the wall. Ciccoli comes across for Sladek. Big hit on Sladek by Kimball. Far side. Burke plays it back to his own blue line. Bendorf. Head to the near side. Ends. Long pass ahead is off the mark. No icing. Kangas wins the race. He's taken into the wall. Ness chases after Kelly. Kangas just got put down by Mikowski, and now he chopped him. Far side. Now Mikowski just chopped Kangas' feet. Meanwhile, they dig in the near corner. This is Mikowski. Dumps one in. Kimball stops it. Ends. Sweeps around to the near side. This is Ends. Ends carries in. Shot goes up and over the net. This is a shot wide by Bauer. Big hit on the far side. As Murphy gets put down. Dumped in. This is Pavel on the attack. Pavel broken up, tipped just wide of the cage. Rahowiak in. Long stretch without a whistle. Down low. Near side, they dig. Pavel down. Squirts free to Belial. This one's dumped in. Mokel out of his net to stop. 6:58. Adams into the middle. Shot save made. Put it front tip. It's in. Ryan Adams.
bounce it though.
I think Brian Adams will get the goal there unassisted. And that ties it up with 6:48 to go in a 1-1 game. Shots even also at 24 aside.
6:48 to play. Toros control off the draw. This is Lovin for Mooch. Shot on, save made. On the attack. Drop back for Kelly. Shot tip out front at Locula. Able to stick with it.
Awesome fans, especially the Rugby Ice Hawks. We hope you found Tank. We hope you enjoyed the ice cream from Stone Cone Creamery from the Rugby Ice Hawks.
Draw to the right of Samuakua. Controlled by the Wings. Up top, Britt just touches it down low.
9-0-0-2.
Far corner, Bendorf.
You can collect your prize of over $600. That's Blue Ticket 830-900.
Centering feed broken up. Sladek on it. Bendorf throws down low. Kimball. Ahead, that passes off the mark. Mucha wins the race, though. He's taken in the wall. Weigel plays to the far side. Bendorf. Toss across. Britt. Thrown down low. Lockerla out of his net. Keeps it moving for Rosenbaum. Played to the far side. Only Murphy was there. Murphy's shot gobbled up by Lockerla for a whistle. Draw will be to the right of Lockerla. One back by the Wings. Kelly tries a shot. It hits traffic. Burke looks in front. And big stop by Rosenbaum after Lockerla made the save. Played to the near side, McGinnis hammers ahead. He finds Ness. Ness touches for Bauer. Poked away from him. Shot, blocker, save. Shot on, save made. Draw to the left of Lankawa. Pavel wins it back. Kalik has trouble with Strada. Pavel steps into him, but Pitters is there. Strada trying to work out of the corner, banks back to the point. Played to the far side. Carried ahead. Eventually taken away, chip towards the Toro zone. The Toros will be sending $1,300 to the Humboldt Broncos Recovery Fund because of the 50-50 and the donation draw, donation box as well. Again, I can't thank Toro fans enough, as now Strada's alone in front. Save made by Lockerla. Rebound cleared out. Logan Britt. Dumped down low. That was offside, though, so the Wings have to peel off. This is Adams Got away with interference on Britt. That allows Dolomer into the zone. Looking back for Adams. His shot goes wide. This is taken away by Adams on the back check. He better be here for the playoffs. Centering feed for Dolomer. Save made. Thrown back in front. No one there for the Toros. Thrown into the corner by Murphy. 3:05. This is Fletcher into the zone. Delays. Shot blocked by traffic and Lance. Touches it into the corner. Then plays ahead for Adams. Taken away by Burke. Thrown in the middle. Bendorf. Shot save made by Lankawa. Bendorf got his own rebound, though. He's working in behind. Lance pokes it away from him. Taylor Lance takes it away, chops it ahead. It'll bounce out to neutral ice. Kelly on the attack, centering feed. Good tie-up by Rosenbaum. Following try goes wide. 2.5 to play here in regulation. Mucha poked free. Good hit on Sicoli by Rosenbaum. That allows Mooch to play back to McGinnis. McGinnis leaves in the far corner for Rosenbaum. Ahead, Lovin into the zone. Lovin poked free. He's taken into the corner. He'll dig down low. Lovin out with it, but it's hacked off his stick, and the Wings will look to go the other way. This is Lovin. This is dumped in. No icing, so Lankawa plays. This is ahead for Kangas. This is Rahowiak ahead on the near side. Ness tangled up behind the play. Meanwhile, Strada falls down, looks to center. It's taken away by Colby Enns. Toros look to rush the other way. Enns ahead for Kangas, gains the line. Kangas finds Kimball. Kimball had his stick tied up. And Strada looks to go the other way. Belial, the only man back for a two-on-one. It's Strada with Burke. It's across for Burke, and he can't finish. Lankawa took the net away. And the Toros poke it out to neutral. Final 40 seconds. It's ahead for Strada. They dig on the far wall. Green. Ahead for Belial. Belial lost the handle. He gets it back. Looks to drop it, but Toro's late to the point. So McGinnis has to just dump it down. It's ahead. 10 seconds left. Chipped ahead, not out. Fletcher still has it. Fletcher dumps it down low. And we're headed to overtime. We'll take a short break, come back with the extra session after these messages here on the Minotauros Network.
Hey guys, my name is Steve Olswanger, Fire Chief from Maryland Heights, Missouri. I love Firehouse Subs because you can feed your whole crew and help your community thanks to Firehouse Subs Catering. If you're planning a tailgate, an office holiday party, or anything in between, Firehouse Subs has crowd-pleasing platters starting at just $5 per person. They'll even deliver to you. And of course, you'll be helping your community because a portion of every purchase at Firehouse Subs goes towards helping first responders in our communities. The more subs folks enjoy, the more Firehouse Subs is able to help save lives.
Firehouse Subs Catering. Choose from sub, salad, or dessert platters for your next group gathering. Platters start at just $5 a person. Visit firehousesubs.com to find a location near you. Firehouse Subs, founded by firemen. Firehouse of America will donate 0.13% of your purchases in 2017 at all U.S. locations to the Firehouse Subs Public Safety Foundation with a minimum donation of $1 million. For full details, visit firehousesubs.com.
The sinister cries haunted Mary through the night. Dawn neared,
and still the voice tormented her. She ran towards the safety of her car, flung open the door, and a coyote had somehow gotten locked inside. But the damaged interior was covered thanks to Farmers Insurance. Coyote Carpool, August 1st, 2015. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Charles Forward, Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your local farmer's agent at 701-838-8144.
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena. Toros and Wings headed to overtime, even at one aside. Toros' goal came from Brian Adams. Aberdeen's goal from Burke. All the other action in the league is done. So this overtime is the end of the regular season for the North American Hockey League. This will be the last regular season goal, and it will be a game winner for one of these two clubs. And Brad, the good thing about making it to overtime, the Toros will finish 27-26 and over 6 500. Or 28-26 and 6. So no matter what, the Toros will finish the year over 500. Lovin, Mooch, and Enns out to start the extra session. Miro finds it. Miro into the zone. He delays. He'll just carry back out to neutral ice. The other good news, this is the last 3-on-3 overtime we have to watch this year. Any overtime in the playoffs will be 5-on-5. Turned over. Lovin tries to stuff it. Can't get it to go. Weigel behind his own net. Lovin steps into him and takes it away. Lovin throws it to the front, but Bendorf takes it away. Burke will work on Colby Enns. Burke can't get through Enns. They joust a little bit after the play. This is Lovin starting up ice. He's got Miro with him. Lovin gains the line. Lost the handle, though. It's ahead for Burke. He gives to Fletcher. Enns is back, though. And the Wings were offside. 4:10 left to go here in the extra session. Toros being outshot 27-26. But obviously we're still tied since we're still playing hockey. Draw in neutral. One by the Wings. Makowski holds. Comes across for Fletcher. It's Adams, Adams, and Rosenbaum. The trio out for the Toros. Rosenbaum holds. Gets into trouble along the far wall. Brian Adams steps in and takes it away from Fletcher. Fletcher muscles him off the puck, though. Adams steps back into him. Adams definitely got away with a hook there.
Yeah, but...
yeah, whatever. It's overtime.
Player's tied up there. Yeah. I don't know what he's supposed to do.
This is Fletcher into the zone. Walking in, shot it up and over. Rebound to the far side. Fletcher finds it. Fletcher trying to get away from Rosenbaum. He cannot. Sokoli. Back for Fletcher. Turnaround try. That goes wide of the cage. And Lockelo will cover. Defensive zone draw coming for the Toros. Strada, Pitters, and Sinard over the wall. And that means Pavel, Belial, and Earn will jump the fence for the Toros. I thought they used to also change sides on 3-on-3 overtime.
They did.
No. Just making sure I wasn't crazy. Turned over. Strada shot. Save made. Lockelo. Rebound controlled by Belial. This is Belial. Starts up ice. Fritz Belial walks right through the Aberdeen defense. Drives the net. Backhand. It's in. Toros win. Lincoln Earn. Win. We'll take a break. We'll come back and recap it. after these messages here on the Toros Network.
I'm Steve Funnyjohn, consumer lender at First Western Bank and Trust and sports enthusiast. The employees at First Western know the importance of teamwork and their day-to-day banking duties to best serve the community. I know the Minot and surrounding area high school and college athletic teams know the importance of teamwork as well. We want to wish all local teams good luck in their athletic endeavors this year. Stay safe on the courts, on the fields, on the rinks, and in the gyms. We look forward to watching you succeed. With familiar faces you know you by name, First Western Bank and Trust, you can bank on us, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
All in one place, you can get a fabulous coffee, the best burger in town, arrange a meeting for up to 30 people, and begin your next trip, whether business or vacation. It's Minot's newest, most architecturally beautiful, versatile structure, the Minot International Airport. The Trestle Tap House and Cafe with Caribou Coffee and customizable meeting spaces are just a couple of the amenities offered. The Minot International Airport. See the world from home.
Hi, Taros fans. I'm Lincoln Earn. When the Taros are on the road, we always stop at Applebee's. They always take care of the Taros, giving us the fuel we need to win away from the Mesa. The boys love to eat there after home games, too. Thanks to Applebee's, when we're on the road, the only thing we're hungry for is a win.
Applebee's 2 for 20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Daniel the Deer danced everywhere. He pranced through fields and jigged through rivers. Then he saw it. What a stage! A place no deer had dared dance before. The hood of a brand new car.
My car.
And the car was covered thanks to Farmers Insurance. Deer Dance Floor, December 1st, 2014. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
I'm Charles Forward Taylor Lance. Call Miranda Schuler, my billet mom, and your locals farmer's agent at 701-838-8144.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at libertytax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Welcome back inside a very happy Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena. Toros win a thriller. And Lincoln Earn gets the game winner in overtime. Brad, you talked about momentum going into the playoffs. The way that third period was, the first two periods of this game did not feel very much like a playoff atmosphere.
No, it amped up.
But the
out.
Third period, when it came in 0-0, the Wings got that quick goal. Suddenly the Toros started hitting, and it felt like a playoff atmosphere. The building was going nuts all period. It was great.
Yeah, that was good intensity in that third. And you know what? As soon as we started playing physical, then things started going our way.
And not just that, but the atmosphere in here was amazing. And you talk about not wanting to limp into the playoffs on a five-game losing streak. Well, mission accomplished.
Big
win.
We had two big missions accomplished. We had great goaltending, and he looked good two nights in a row, so his stamina is still there. And then we win in overtime, and that's huge, huge lift going into this playoffs.
It certainly is. And, you know, now looking forward to next weekend, the Toros not just split with the Aberdeen Wings again this weekend. The Toros split with the Aberdeen Wings this weekend, but now they go into the postseason knowing that they won tonight, and they didn't even use their full lineup either night, right?
Like, no.
They had a lot of guys in who wouldn't normally be in. The Wings, they went full bore the last two nights, so you get that extra boost of confidence from knocking them off tonight with, you know,
three-quarters of a lineup.
Yeah, you know. Now you get to throw Nolan Sawchuk back out there, Sam Foose back out there. Sam Foose is a guy who spent the first half of the season at a Division I program.
Mm-hmm.
He was redshirted for injury. Then he came back, basically, were his rehab assignment. You know, Nolan Sawchuk's committed to go Division I. So you put those two guys back in. And then up front, you know, you've kind of taken turns sitting forwards. You'll have Keenan Lund back in. You'll have, you know, I assume Talbot will draw back in. maybe.
From there, I don't know. I mean,
yeah. I mean, you know, Bauer and Ness are going to be out for sure. They're not eligible for the playoffs, so it'll be real interesting to see how things line up next Friday in Aberdeen.
Very, very interesting, but great momentum going into it, and there was an exciting night here at the Pepsi Arena.
Well, that'll do it for us here. We've got a silent auction to go take care of. So we'll talk to you, or I'll talk to you next Friday night from the ODI Center in Aberdeen at 7:15 to start Game 1 of the Central Division semifinals. We hope you enjoyed tonight's broadcast. We know you enjoyed the outcome. Toros win, and they score the last goal of the NAHL regular season. We'll talk to you tomorrow, next Friday from Aberdeen.
This has been a presentation of Minotauros Hockey. Visit MinotaurosHockey.com to stay up to date on all things Toros. This broadcast was brought to you by Farmers Union Insurance, Gooseneck Implement, Mattress Firm, Liberty Tax, and Coulter Energy. Minotauros Hockey, join the charge.
I don't know. He just ran down. He's coming down.